Okay, so last time we left, had an interesting encounter with a couple individuals, presumably from the Ivory Tower, who showed up to try and assassinate Pi in the night. They were stopped by someone else who came in and essentially dealt with one of them and kind of took control of the other. And this lady identified herself as a servant of the Shadow or of the Dark Lord. And told you guys that they want you to continue doing what you're doing, and therefore they're not going to kill you yet, was her words. She said, but don't think we actually care much about you. You know, if you go off the deep end, we have no hesitation in doing what we need to, more or less. So that visit occurred, and she said she was going to send off the other assassin back to the tower to report that they were successful. So in theory, they will believe that Pi is dead. Also during the same night, your best friend, Mr. Aragast, got up and walked off with a slit throat. The next day, you guys followed him, catching up to him fairly quickly as you were on horse. He was not. And you heard him having a conversation with some other Kren that he had met up with in the forest. And he also plans to report back that it was a success, and that while they weren't able to capture Pi, they at least killed him. He took a moment to put on his clothes, as he had been put on some new clothes. He had been stripped of everything by you guys, and he stepped in the forest to do so, stared directly at the group of you, gave you a big old toothy grin, and then walked back to the Kren without saying another word. So with that, you guys return to the village to be welcomed by a bunch of impaled Kren corpses.
Yeah, there was that, wasn't there?
Yeah, I forgot about that.
And
redecorating.
And you guys had a discussion essentially saying that the next best thing you thought to do now that at least the Kren will be off your backs for a little bit and in theory sold the tower would be to secure Briek and make these people finally live in a safe place. And I think the best way you guys determined to do that, at least last session, was you're going to go hunt down these goblins. So we're going to say it's the next day after you guys had slept. It's the morning of the day you want to depart. You haven't quite departed yet, so if there's any small things you want to take care of before you leave, let me know. But otherwise, yeah.
Antimaeus is going to want to talk to Valdra and Artana. Artana, is that it?
Okay, yeah, Artana.
And just make sure that... I'll ask Valdra specifically to... make sure all the weapons and everything get put back in our basement.
Okay.
Because no one needs them to train with. They can just use, you know, makeshift sticks and stuff. Yeah. I just wanted to train them on actually, like, putting it on, wearing it.
Which was already provided earlier. Elgamar had those sticks and whatever for
he has a bunch of fashion spears or something.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So, and then I'm going to ask, away from the group, I'll sneak away from the group when I ask this, but I'll ask them to take down the bodies and bury them.
Okay. All right.
And then, I want to see if Artana is going to stick around or if she's going to be gone by the time I get back.
Artana will let you know that her understanding is that if she leaves, she dies right now, so she'll be sticking around to help until you guys essentially give her leave to go. And to her, she states that's better than just being killed outright, so she's essentially indebted to you until you determine her wills. But she does make a point of stating that she hopes that her obedience and that her willingness to help does reflect well upon your decision to let her go one day. But yeah, she'll be here when you get back.
I'll definitely promise that she'll be able to go where she wants one day. Go where she wants one day. And I'm going to leave it ambiguous.
You wanted to go to the afterlife, right?
Yeah. And then just ask them, I don't know how long we're going to be, so if they could prepare the supplies. Because I think they probably had some prepared before we the whole thing happened. They probably, because they were preparing for a shipment, weren't they?
Yep. Yeah, so, they wanted to get one off before winter.
Okay, so hopefully that's still prepared, and then we can leave soon as we get back with it to get more supplies. But if it's not, just tell them to get prepared, and then the 11 people should be training as well.
Okay. All right, they'll make sure that that's done. Valdra will specifically ask you, do we have permission to pull the weapons and armor out of the basement if things happen?
Of course.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just not for training.
Okay. Makes sense. Okay, so they'll each give you a nod there, Antimaeus, and they'll depart and start making what preparations they can. Okay, anything else anyone else would like to do before you leave?
I'll grab some healer kits if I can. I like to grab, like, 11.
11 full kits, or just, like, uses?
Uses, yeah.
Yeah, there shouldn't be an issue scrounging up enough.
While everyone's getting ready, I'm gonna go make sure Necromancer is fed and still alive. And talk to him just a little bit, but I'm not casting anything.
Yeah.
I still have four uses worth for healer's kits as well.
Yeah, if you want to take a couple as well, or Scott, you can do that.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can add like two to what you've got, and then I will take the remaining 11. And that's just essentially, to be clear, ripped up cloth from clothes of people that have died and that sort of thing that obviously don't need. And
just kind of scrape off the crusty blood and.
Well, I mean, they had additional clothes; they didn't have a ton, but you know. And then like salves and that sort of thing that, you know, are easily prepared with herbs and are probably readily on hand because people get injured, you know, cutting wood and that kind of shit all the time. So yeah, that'll be mainly what those are comprised of.
I'll go to the baker's house and knock on it and tell Alias to leave the baker's daughter alone and let's get going.
But come on, guys. I was actually gonna say I was gonna do like a little perimeter search around the village just to see if there was any tracks from goblins coming back to visit or anything like that.
Sure.
But I guess I got distracted.
Well, maybe she just comes out and says he already left this morning.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Just give me a survival check there, Alex, and we will see what you find.
No. Math. 13.
Okay. You don't find any new tracks. You're pretty confident that because of the way the snow's been falling and it hasn't been, like, throwing buckets of snow or anything else recently, you can probably still follow the tracks of the scouts that came out from the day before. It'll be difficult, but you should be able to follow them. But yeah, nothing.
Yeah. Cool.
Pythagoras.
Yes.
Are we attacking hard, or are we going to kind of like probe and then decide what to do?
I think a tactical approach is best, so yeah.
Do we need the
careful
horse?
Apparently they have a good shin attack.
Yeah.
yes they
are.
Are we
bringing the sled?
Yeah.
I assume you always bring the sled.
Yeah, I drag it.
You're pulling it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I was going to ask, did you want me to bring the horse so that we could carry stuff? Or just leave it?
Necromancer could pull it. Just saying.
Can he lift the weight of his own belly right now?
Between Maple and Almagar, I think we can get that sled moving, no problem. I'll be there pulling the sled. Mush, mush!
Down all fours.
Why did I say this?
Yeah.
So Maple, you go and comfort Necromancer a little bit then.
Yeah.
He He seems still well fed from the day before. Maybe a little bit less of a food baby going on in his stomach, but still seems fairly content with life at the moment.
Well, I'll put down some fresh hay for him and let him know we'll be gone for a little bit and to try and stay alive for Pi's sake.
Okay. All right.
His therapy pet. To certainly deal with his PTSD from when you know, just growing up on the streets and whatnot.
Scarring version times, yeah. Alright, so is there anything else you guys like to do before you depart?
Well, no, I guess we should talk, or do you want to bring horses, or should I bring the sled?
Well, those are probably going to be mostly in the forest. We're not going to be horses are...
The only thing I was thinking about for horses is if we want to pack anything back without having to go there and then go back, right?
Well, that's why I figured
if we find tons of armor or we find tons of something, then we might need, something. But that's what I'm saying. Like, if we're going to go there, just attack and hopefully kill them all and then come back later and get whatever we need, then that's fine. I don't think we need to bring the horse.
Yes, maybe if Maple has her sled anyway, then anything we do find should be able to strap onto theirs.
Yeah.
All right, so... the time being, bringing just the sled.
Yeah.
All right.
And if you ever want a break, obviously I can pull it for a while. It's funny because I was thinking we should have like a couple sleds or a good sized sleigh for us to go to like the city and back in the wintertime.
Well, we are working with a bunch of villagers who sell some good wood that you could craft to the sleigh, I'm sure.
I think that'd be a good idea. Well, wintertime, right? Again, if it's realistically in the middle of a blizzard or whatever, a cart with four wheels and a horse isn't going to go anywhere if you got 5 feet of snow. Basically, as we're walking, like first heading out, so like before we even get to the to the tree line there, I was just going to show Antimaeus the two pouches of vials that I found.
Okay.
Because I kind of have an idea, but I mean, I just kind of see what he thinks of them. I assume you would have a better understanding of what these are for.
I'll have to take a look at it more in depth with my supplies, but yeah, I'll take a look at it later.
Okay, I'll actually give both of the pouches to you.
Okay.
You might get better use out of this.
So, just as a quick reminder, those were two pouches. They each have five vials in them that were kind of just, they're like maybe 2 inches big and are just in little loops inside those pouches. Okay.
So all much right. I'd like to try them.
Okay. So you guys are going to depart then? Okay. What's your marching order looking like? How are you guys going to move through here? The path that Alias is probably setting you on is no more than two people shoulder width across, easily at least. So bear that in mind.
I can lead the way since I'm kind of doing the tracking.
I'll go last because I'll be pulling the sleigh. So
okay. I'll walk beside Alias.
Okay. I'll go in the back as well.
And then Antimaeus will
hang that way I can ride the sleigh while Maple pulls it.
Yeah, I'll be somewhere in the middle.
Okay. So, you guys trudge along on this path. Alias, can I please get another survival from you?
Ooh, 25.
That was a little beastie.
Yeah.
Was that on Jordan's end?
Not sure.
No? Oh.
I think it might have been a motorcycle driving by or something.
Oh, here I'm thinking it's like the THX intro or whatever with the subwoofers.
All right. So you guys travel successfully, at least to your knowledge, for at least an hour and a half or so. Alias is leading you on a path that he's pretty confident the goblins have followed to this point. You are identifying tracks they're difficult, but you're just really on top of your game today, and you're picking up small signs, you know, broken branches, some depressed mud that's just a little bit less uneven, you're pretty sure it's from a footprint, so on and so forth. So you're really finding your way. Before long, you actually get to a point where multiple paths have all kind of met up in this one area. Clearly, there might have been like a little camp or something here at some point, but then they all continue back another direction. So essentially, there are four different paths coming from here towards different areas, and then one path that leads to this spot. So it looks like a bunch of people walked together and then went four different ways, essentially. And you're following one of those four ways right now.
Okay, so we're coming from one of the four.
Exactly,
and
yeah.
And there's still like a main road ahead of us, if we're in one direction.
There's like a main path, and then there's three other directions where people split off that was clearly not Briek.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Do the tracks that we're following seem to come from the main path, or just like a jumble of tracks everywhere now?
They all, like, all four branches seem to come from that main path. So, in theory, wherever they all came from would be up
that
main path.
Keep going.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, unless you want to track down some individual groups that went other directions, that's probably the best route. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll whisper to Alias, has there been any other, like, recent traffic on any of the other paths?
About as recent as the one that went to Briek.
Okay. Obviously, I would share that.
The people in the back should be, like, aware of that, so that just in case when we get on this main path, they come up from behind.
Not a bad idea.
Because we killed the Briek.
I'm assuming
once.
Who knows where the other ones went and if they're coming back.
All right, so you're going to continue on then?
I think so.
Are you sure? Last chance.
I'm never sure anymore.
Be a piece of advice, you never will be.
I know.
on that prompting, I'll pull out my crossbow and load it.
You travel for another about 20 or so minutes. Before Alias, Almagar, and Antimaeus, the three of you start to notice a couple things in the forest around you, namely occasional little wood snap and that sort of thing. And it wasn't really alarming at first because animals move through these areas. You know, it can definitely happen, but the sounds have traveled about the same distance that you have since you've moved from the last time you heard them. So you're pretty confident something else is either following this path or you.
So from behind, though, for sure?
Behind slightly on either side of the path. So there's definitely more than one thing following you.
And you said Maple saw this too? Or hears this too?
Antimaeus, Almagar, and Alias. Just the three.
Okay, the three amigos. Oh, yeah! Screw Unyielding, we can be the amigos.
Form our own group.
I'll attempt to hide and kind of go off into the bushes.
I'm gonna just, kind of look at Maple, and I'm gonna kind of give her like a little bit of a, just kind of like something's, you know, without making it look like, oh, look, there's something in the bush.
Yeah, and I'm gonna kind of keep going on to make it as if I, you know, I'm still unaware, but I'll definitely be a little bit more alert.
Sure. Well, if I'm being nudged and whatnot, I want to do a perception check to see if I notice anything now that it's brought to my attention.
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
15.
So you actually are not hearing these noises that these guys are describing. The three of you have actually noticed that they've more or less gone silent as well. Antimaeus, can I get a stealth check from you, please?
14.
So I don't know if this is, I assume this is going to be either goblins or more Kren. So I'm actually just going to turn and run straight, like probably not very far, like, you know, 15, maybe 20 feet, but whatever, just straight to the bush and then pull up my weapon and...
All right.
And like straight into my, I figure I'm going to run into something here pretty quick because it sounded pretty close. I'm going to make enough noise, like I'm going to like, rah!
Are you
so that
running...
the rest of the party knows, that are obviously going to notice I'm doing it.
Sure. Are you going to be running into the bush in the direction that Antimaeus went, or the opposite?
Oh, I'd probably go the opposite. I'd see him kind of sneak off, and then I did see him sneak off, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you guys
I did. Oh, okay, shit.
And they were behind beside us, right?
Sorry, if I see him sneak off, right, I'm not gonna do what I just did. I'm gonna be
prepared,
ready to do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. No, that makes yeah. Rather than yeah, no, I better yeah, I'll do that instead. Sorry.
Don't worry.
But, no, you've already committed.
You are now 30 feet into the forest.
And, yeah.
We'll get back there.
It's funny.
One day, guys.
I charged in right behind Antimia as he was sneaking.
I got you, buddy.
Okay. So, Elias, you said you're still continuing forward slightly, right?
Yeah. Okay. I might slow down a little bit, okay. But I'm going to try and make it as if, you know, I'm still just doing my thing.
Sure. Mm-hmm. So, as you're moving along the path, still keeping an eye on the surroundings around you, you're going to notice that there's a particularly large tree kind of off the path a little bit, but you're pretty sure you see a little greenish hand sticking out from kind of where the roots are of the tree. It seems to be coming out of some like piled sticks and grass and that sort of thing. And keep in mind that this forest is very thick, guys. I didn't really do a great description, but it's thick, so there's not a ton of snow on the ground here. It's generally falling through from when the weight on the boughs are too high, so there's not a ton of snow here. But, yeah.
Cool. Can I still see Antimaeus at this point? Or is he, like, he's gone?
He's gone.
Okay. Did I see the hand move at all? And he looks like he's in a pile, or it's kind of like sticking out, like holding on to something.
No, it looks like it's, maybe the body is underneath this pile, but there's like a little hand that's still sticking out.
Could be a corpse, could be sleeping under twigs.
Yeah.
Or lying in wait.
Well, one thing you'll notice is that there's no lump underneath like the pile of leaves or anything else. It's pretty flat to where the hand is.
Oh.
So
I have a feeling it might be a decapitated arm.
Perhaps.
What? Go poke it. No.
Does it... You said there's a larger tree. Does it kind of open into a clearing? Or is it still like tiny path?
Just a particularly... Yeah, particularly big one. Yeah. It's, you know, probably a person's height in width. So it's quite large.
Okay. How far ahead is it? Sorry.
About 20 feet before you notice the hand.
Okay, cool. I will definitely stop.
Yeah.
And I'm just gonna get my hands ready on my swords and just kind of like scan the area, look around, and kind of give like a hold sign to the other guys, and see if I notice anything.
Sure. Okay. All right. Antimaeus, you've snuck off into the woods. What would you like to do in there?
I'm going to wait until I can't really hear the group walking anymore, which apparently is now.
Yes.
And then I'm going to wait for a couple seconds, like a minute, to hear if the noise picks up again to follow the group.
Pie and Maple, what would you guys like to do at this point?
Well, I just got signaled to stop, so until that flag went on, I was still just going, trying to look around, but still not seeing what everyone's all getting huffy about here. Like, whatever.
Pretty dead silent.
Oh, I'll go up to her and just whisper to her there, there's something in the bush. Kreiner Goblin's not sure, but
is Almagar here too? Almagar, you're still with us? Yeah? You didn't run
away. Oh, yeah. I was going to charge in, but yeah, after Antimaeus went, I forgot. Yeah, let's not blow his cover and maybe he can get the.
Let him do his thing.
Yeah, because Almagar has noticed that when Antimaeus disappears like that, shit happens. Like, shit gets done.
All right.
I'll tell Maple and Almagar to kind of like form up so our backs are back to back, and then I'll just ready my action.
I kind of not yell, but I'm just gonna be like a bit of a growl because I'm gonna like, come on, just either fucking attack or fuck off.
I'll drop holding the sleigh and I'll pull out my spear. Move away from them some, because there's too many people in one area. So I'll just move up maybe about 10 feet from Pi and Almagar, more into the middle, and then I'll stop because we were flagged to stop. So.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, and I'm gonna pull my hand axes. Not the great sword, but close quarters, man. Yeah.
So from above, you guys, the boughs of the trees rustle and a bunch of birds fly through them and off into the sky.
Above us?
What kind of birds? Were they normal looking birds?
Yeah, they look like some kind of birds that doesn't fly to different times.
Well, it's just because it's winter, so, you know.
None of those goblin birds.
Well, hey. No. We were attacked by things birds. Before, remember? That's the...
Oh, yeah, you've seen these birds around. They don't seem to be too bothered by the cold. Something that nests all season long. So, yeah, they fly through the boughs of the trees. Otherwise, it remains silent.
What way are they going? Flying?
They kind of flew across the path. So, from your right to your left. So, you guys are traveling west. So, north to south.
I'm going to keep the... I'm going to turn my attention then to the north.
Okay.
Are we headed? Sorry, we're headed west still?
Yep.
Cool. I'm going to slowly approach the arm. Very alertly. I'm going to look throughout the trees and see if anything's sticking up there.
Okay. All right, how close are you going to get to it?
Assuming nothing prompts me to stop before I get to it, I'll probably, at 7 or 8 feet out, I'm going to draw my swords.
Okay.
And then I will get up to it and poke it.
Okay.
If nothing happens. Okay.
Can I get a perception check from everyone, please?
Natural 20.
Nice.
Of course, so...
Natural 2 in your
face! So 23.
Nice.
19 for me.
17.
It's not when you want the natural 20s.
No. So 17. I'm... Yeah. 5.
All right. Poor Alagar.
I heard him the first time, and I'm like, I'm just hearing things.
Oh gosh, it's just birds, don't worry about it.
Totally fine.
As you draw your swords 7 or 8 feet away from this, you're pretty sure you see some movement underneath the branches and such.
Well, how does that go? Stab first, ask questions later.
Goblin hand?
That's sticking out?
Yeah.
Yeah. The hand didn't move. Something under the branches and stuff did, though. Then the hand has stayed quite quite still.
But it's in the same kind of pile.
Yeah, the wrist goes underneath the twigs and stuff.
Yeah, I'm just gonna stab it.
Stab into the
stab the pile? Yes. Oh, look, it's one of the villagers that's been out. No, it's getting up.
It's probably my wolves.
Oh, Dalton. Dalton. Oh, Dalton.
What happened to Dalton again?
Jontaine's dead. Jontaine's not.
Oh!
He's back in Aridel.
This is just dawning on Elmagar now.
Oh, I'm just trying to remember. Like, I remember something.
They were brothers, but it wasn't the same guy. Okay. So you stab the pile.
Pile dies.
Kill the jackrabbit.
You stab into the pile, and it actually feels hollow. You don't really you feel it bust through a bunch of branches, but then it feels like it just goes into a hole underneath.
Huh. Can I, like, flick up the pile?
Sure.
It's like a mess of twigs and whatever, and see what's underneath.
Definitely. Yeah, so you put up the pile.
It was actually a trap for the goblin. Seems like.
So the hand was definitely severed. It is detached from any body. You flick up the leaves. Where your blade was stuck, you see for a moment several eyes staring at you, attached to quite a furry body. And it lunges out at you as a giant wolf spider comes out from hiding.
Ooh!
How giant? Like
bigger than the ones in Kelowna.
Darn! Yeah, it's like a beast. No. I would say that it's like if you were to take its butt to its head, it's probably 6 to 7 feet long.
Oh, okay, that giant.
It's a big one. Okay. Yeah.
Cool.
Okay.
Now, is this a wolf spider, or is this, like, a wolf spider? Like, a wolf with spider legs, or is this, like,
no, no, sorry, I'm sorry. It's, like, definitely okay. A wolf Never spider, knows, not, like, a wolf spider.
Can you imagine that thing run?
I can imagine what it would look like making a web. That's where I went. Yeah, exactly. You know, right, like Alex. They drag their ass around the floor.
I need a Constitution saving throw, please. And you also take 3 points of damage.
Just from like shitting yourself.
Well, this is gonna end terribly. 7.
An additional 7 points of damage.
Excellent. Can I also get that other D20 for me?
So what ended up happening there is it lunged onto you, it bit its kind of mandibles into you, and as well as its stinger, because this thing's like full frontal on your body kind of thing, so its stinger dug into your leg, and you felt something course from it into your leg, like you just felt pressure being inserted, and then the burning occurs, and that's where the second kind of thing came from. After it kind of lets go of your body, the burning subsides, but yeah, it hurt.
But now I've got like an inch and a half wide hole in my leg.
This is not the shoulder.
3 inches. At least it's not the shoulder. I mean, he might have missed if you went for the shoulder, though.
Yeah, straight through. Like, what? Someone tries to do like the Vulcan Earth pinch on you, and you're like, nothing there, buddy.
Off with their arm.
So the rest of you, except Almagar, do notice, as you're looking around, you hear this kind of commotion over from Alias, and with that, you start to see some things in the boughs of the trees start to slowly climb along. They look like other large spiders climbing through the trees, and a few of them have their eyes on. I need initiative, please.
Huh.
21.
20. 21. I was 20.
16 for me.
Antimaeus.
22.
And Alias.
12. Keeping consistent.
Okay. Antimaeus, what would you like to do?
What do you mean? He's already trapped in the web. snuck off the trail straight into a web. Like,
just hanging there. Well, this sucks.
If I can see any movement in the tree, then I will shoot at it.
Okay.
17.
That definitely hits.
So 21.
All right, you fire your crossbow. You strike. You hear this kind of squeal from this thing as it falls out of the tree, and its legs shudder and then close in. Okay. With that, the trees start erupting and shaking, and you can see many more of these things running around in the tree boughs and getting in position. You also see a couple climb up from holes that were also within tree bases as they slowly scurry out and look you guys with their eyes.
Can I use my move action to run?
Like, of course.
Yes, I'm gonna use dash to move twice my movement speed and run by everyone farther down the trail.
Only because we're trying to be really specific with rules. Oh no, you're rogue. You can do dash. I forgot.
Yes.
Ignore me.
Yes.
Okay. All right, you. So Almagar, Maple, and Pi. You saw Alias ahead on the road get tackled by one of these things. You guys notice a few of these other things crawling around in the trees above you, and then you just see Antimaeus sprint out of the trees and just run down the road.
That's actually a pretty good idea. At least get away from this nest so we're not ready for it.
Okay.
Would it be possible? I guess it depends on initiative, right? I was going to say, can I just follow him?
Maple, what would you like to do?
I'm going to turn around and yell at Pi and Elgmarta, grab the sled. I think we need to get the hell out of here. And with that, I'm going to turn and I'm going to start running to try and catch up to the other two.
All right.
I'll grab the sled and look. Oh, right. It's not my turn yet. Boy,
this is Pi, what would you like to do?
I'm going to cast light on my shield and then I will follow them.
You that are close to you seem to not like light too much. Start running off. Okay. Almagar.
What I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to have one hand axe and then grab the sled and try to go as fast as I can.
All right.
Without getting...
And their Alias goes for round two.
Of course.
Just make contact, so I do need a constitution save against you. You take 5 points of damage.
Twelve.
That is sufficient. Alright. So you just take the 5 points of damage.
Only 5.
As the thing lunges at you and bites again. You also see your party running by you as fast as they possibly can.
Wait, are they running back? Or...
They're running forwards, to my knowledge, right? You guys are running further.
Yeah, they're running forward.
Yeah, okay. I was running up to them, though, so I would be...
Oh,
I wouldn't
bad.
Be running okay. past...
You're not running past. You see Antimaeus rip by you.
I was going to say... Everybody else coming.
I'll keep going a little bit further. I'm not trying to get away. I don't want to be right in the middle of all these spiders, at least.
For sure. Makes sense to me. All right. So several of these things bust down to the path and kind of beside the path, and they start chasing you guys. Alias, you see a couple sort of not come to you, but sort of run chasing after Antimaeus, and then a few others are surrounding you and the rest of the party. Alias, what would you like to do?
Is this thing, like, on top of me? I'm on the ground,
no,
right?
No. It jumped at you, kind of clung to you and bit you, and then went off, bit you again, but it's standing kind of in front of you.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It's scurrying around you, trying to get a good position.
Do I only have one focused on me right now?
By the looks of it, yeah.
Okay. And so I'm kind of in the middle right now. Antimaeus is there. And
yeah.
Everybody else is coming at me. Part.
It's kind of behind you, yeah.
Cool. I'm going to try and take some revenge on this little bastard.
All right.
Because that hurt. yeah, so I'm just going to have some fun.
Okay.
26.
Well, it's definitely a hit.
Holy smokes.
Sorry. 22. I can't count, but...
Good to roll a natural 22.
And 13.
13 is a hit as well.
All right. 12 points damage.
Nice. All right. You slash this thing and stab it in one of the eyes, and the thing just kind of shudders and then also rolls up its back, and its legs just curl up in this.
I will spit on him.
Okay. You spit.
You have angered the spider queen.
All right, Antimaeus.
Running.
Yeah, I'll look back to see how many are chasing me.
But it's literally just us that are chasing you.
You see at least three coming after you right now.
I keep running.
Okay. Now, the path you guys were following was not—it's not like a road, or it's not like a dirt path. It was a trudge path, right? So you're just trying your best to stay on it.
Yep.
Okay. Do you have survival? And if not, can you just give me a wisdom check?
Sure. 20, not natural.
Nice. Okay. So keep on sprint. Okay. Maple. So you've caught up to Alias at this point. He just nuked one of these spiders. There's a bunch of others scurrying around.
Gonna yell at him, are you all good? Are we running? Are you gonna stay here and fight all day? Let's go. And with that, I'm gonna start running to up to where I saw Antimaeus going.
Yeah. Alright. What would you like to do?
How many spiders are there?
A few chasing Antimaeus, you know, like 8 or 9 kind of hovering around you guys in the immediate area.
Yeah, I'll keep running.
Okay. Alright. Alan, what would you like to do?
Where, Alias said, like, yeah, Alias, you haven't started running yet, right?
Not yet, no.
No. I'll basically just hang back with him and just to, yeah.
Sure. But, so you'll just kind of ready your action, waiting for him to go, and then you'll go when he does?
Yeah. Not that I'm one for running, but,
Spiders is a situation.
It's not like I'm going to regret not getting that kill. For spiders.
Anything bigger than me and outnumbering me? Eh.
Actually, yeah, these are big spiders. Even I'm like, this is like barbarian spiders.
Yeah. I could probably ride one of these.
Dire yeah. Spiders.
Hey, there we go. Maple needs to like speak with Animal, and then she has a new mount. Could you imagine riding into town on a wolf spider?
All 8 legs, yeah.
Yeah. Huh. Like a half howl, okay. Half, yeah.
So these things, you two are getting prepared to run. You're kind of, you held your ground for Alias to kind of get him going. These things, while that's happening, try and take the jump on each of you. One strikes each of you. So Alias, you take 6 points of damage. Almagar, you take 6 points of damage. And I need a constitution save for both of you, please. as a few of them are just like nipping at your ankles and you feel a tooth sink in once in a while.
Oh, nine.
I'm good about that nine.
Guys.
Four?
Oh my.
Well, it's probably about to get better.
Yeah, so you take an additional 7 points of damage from, again, this burning sensation that starts to course through your veins. Almagar, you take 5 points of damage from a similar feeling from where one of these things bit you. This stings. Okay, and then you both start sprinting, I'm assuming. Are you running?
Yeah, and is it... While I'm running, I'm just gonna, like, massage my leg and cure wounds it. Before I trip over the branch and die.
So, your choice is this. So, these guys are all sprinting.
Okay.
You can definitely do that. You'll be a little bit slower for this period of running than the rest of your comrades.
I see him. Well,
knowing that, do I think I can at least get a little bit further away from the spiders? Or do I feel like if I'm not on a full sprint, I'm probably gonna get ganked again?
These things are probably gonna catch up to you if you're not on a full sprint. Yeah, they're fast. You saw a few scurry after Antimaeus, and they were right on his heels.
Okay, I'll hold off on that then.
Okay. You're just gonna go.
Yeah, before I just, like, waste my time and die anyways.
All right, yeah. All right, so you and Almagar just sprint on. Okay, Antimaeus, three keeping pace with you, but you do you continue to run?
Yep. I'll throw snow at them.
Okay. Alright, Maple.
Snowball, stay, why not?
Continue following Antimaeus?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay. Pie?
Or at least if I can see him.
Yeah. Yeah, so far you can. You can see him ducking and dodging in between trees.
How far back is Almagar and Alias from me?
They're about like 60 feet behind at this point.
I'll slow down a little bit just to catch up to them. Additional 30 feet.
You guys see 8 or so of these things chasing after you. They're not even trying to hide anymore. They're just on a full-on 8-legged sprint.
Just like drooling, ready to eat us.
You hear this kind of squee, squee. Throughout for several of them, they seem to be squeeing in joy of their new meat. Almagar and Alias, are you going to continue running?
I'll keep running until at least run up, catch up to the party.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys can reach Pi, and you'll still have some room to move if the three of you want to continue running at that point.
Okay. Well, again, I don't like the idea of running blindly through the forest either. We're just running into some other... but there's at least we're not surrounded now. At least they're behind us. We have a little bit of control.
Do I think if I slow down a little bit now that they'll go for Pythagoras and Algamar before they come for me?
You have no idea how these things think. But...
Well, if I could, I'd like to put two bodies between me and the spiders.
Okay, so
I like obviously, yeah.
I'll take the rear for you guys there because I feel confident with the light shields. So
you guys run and just halt a couple moments. I'm assuming you're healing yourself.
I need to.
Okay, so you guys halt for a couple moments, heal yourself. Pi, you put your shield up behind
Alias. I'll stand right beside Pi.
Okay, all right. So the three of you are holding the fort.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna make a stand.
That's a little better.
Don't worry, I'll save the rogue.
All right. Can I get a perception check, please?
16.
Okay. It wasn't too hard to see, so don't worry too much. Especially because on the path in front of you, there's a large web strung between trees with several goblin corpses. You would have really had to have not been paying attention to see this thing, but, you know, critical failures happen, so I gotta check. But yeah, so there's several goblins that clearly have been stuck in the trees, that have been in the web between the trees, that haven't been quite yet plucked off of said web, but they all appear about to be unconscious or dead. One occasionally twitches.
Is there, with my perception, can I see if there's a gap underneath it or to the sides or anything like that?
Oh yeah, you could run around this thing. You're just going into more of the brush.
Sweet.
But it does reach from ground to fairly high.
If I look back and I see how close Maple is?
Maple is pretty close to you. The other guys are far enough back where you can't see them.
Yeah, no, that's fine. But is she, like, within swinging range if I stop?
She could make it to you and potentially swing at something, yes. But she's like 30 feet behind you right now, ish.
Okay. Maple, what's your run speed? Are you faster than me? Do you have 40?
I'm at 30. I don't get 40 for a while, but later... Oh, later. I got some surprises for you guys.
Yeah, you're probably a little bit running it. Like, I know you're running the sprinty tram, Jordan, but you're probably a little bit slower only because you're trying to still pay attention to the path.
Yeah.
Where she just following you.
How are these three spiders approaching from behind? Are they, like, side to side or dodging around trees as well?
They're more so in the brush. They're not, like, right behind you on this path. They're kind of to the left and right of you, a couple on the left.
So if I, like... quickly changed directions and ran the other way.
They'd probably have to come and circle back around. They're not going to jump in your path. They would.
Sweet. I'll use disengage just to make it, you know, more plausible, and then I'll kind of like turn tail and run towards Maple, pretty much.
All right. So, as you run towards.
And then I'll pull my dagger and short sword.
Maple, Antimans has run to you, he's drawn his weapons.
Are we fighting here? I already have my spear out, so I'll just kind of get my shield down and kind of look behind me to see if there's anything right behind me.
I will yell that they're trying to get us caught in webs that they've put across the path.
Do we keep going? Or should we wait for the others? So I look back, I'm like, oh.
Kill them. Kill them all.
Okay, yeah. So there's nothing directly behind you, luckily, but you can see the three that are kind of turning direction to come towards you guys. That were chasing at me.
How far away are they? Can I get to them, or... poke them at them with my spear?
They're like 15-ish feet away, having to turn around. I mean, you can definitely go up to them. They're a little bit in the brush off the side of this path, but you can definitely attack them.
I'll try and poke then with my spear, since we seem to be killing things now, not running, so... I'll do it.
You take a few wide strides forward and stab them.
Yeah. D2 to hit?
Okay.
Yeah. They're spiders. They're big, right?
Yeah. Easy, big.
10 damage.
Nice. Okay. So you stab this thing, and it recoils and puts a couple of its like legs up in front of its face, and it just huddles back from you. What would you like to do?
Could I, like, hold my action till Alias has done his stuff, and then once they start running, I'll just go with them?
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so these guys are starting to crowd around. Pretty confident there's about 8 of them now. Apparently you guys getting in the way of the spiders has been fairly effective at keeping Alias protected. They do collide with shield thereby and come at you. Algar, the pummeling, you're trying to keep them off you with your sword and your bat in the back and such. Two do manage to poke their way through you to get a total of 5 points of damage. I need constitution saves from you, please. And Pi, you're a little more lucky. Your shield's probably made pretty well, but one still gets a sneaker through. You take 3 points of damage. I need
Could I use my action to stab that one?
Yeah, definitely.
10 and 13.
Okay.
25.
Nice. Salmagar from the first wound. It burns a little bit, not quite as badly as the last one. You take 2 damage.
Oh, sorry, that wasn't the Constitution. I forgot about that.
Oh, yeah, nice.
Same thing.
Nice. All right, but yeah, it's definitely a hit. Okay.
7 damage.
Just swing at this thing. It's a shrill stab. Deep reddish. Okay. So, Pi will pick up with the second half of your turn here. What would you like to do? Do you want to run with these guys, like you said?
Yeah.
You'll run with them? Okay. All right. Almagar, are you running?
Sorry to... Pi, like everyone else isn't running yet, right? They're fighting.
Pi stabbed one, so he made an attack. He's getting prepped to run.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. No, I'm gonna attack. Yeah.
All right.
I'll take a nice big swing at. I'm sure. Well, there's several in front of me, I guess.
Yeah. Staring around, even trying to find good positions. Narrow it down.
Oh yeah, Alex, I have a 18 armor class now because I took that studded leather. Just so you know.
Alright. Yeah, I'll make that adjustment. Thank you.
So that's going to be 12 to hit.
Okay, that will hit.
Oh. Ah, 13 damage.
Oh, nice. And so you smack this thing and you make a big cleave right in its head, and it just falls to the ground dead.
That's alright.
Are you going to hold your ground, Almagar? Or are you going to start running at this point?
For now, I'm going to hold my ground.
Okay. Alright, Alias, what would you like to do? Pi and Almagar so far have stood and fought.
Am I allowed to use Cure Wounds again?
Yeah, do you have?
Yeah.
As long as you have I've got
3 spell slots, so I can do the same one again. Okay,
yeah.
I'm gonna do that before I foolishly die again, because that's my thing. and then I'm gonna get ready to fight after that, if that's a thing I can do in the same. I don't know.
You won't be able to swing a sword. You'll be able to either run or prepare yourself for next.
Yeah, I'll prepare myself then. Yeah.
As an important note here too, Pi and Almagar, I'm not sure if you guys have actually seen Alias use healing magic or any really big magical effects yet. So you are noticeably seeing him tending his wounds and unnaturally.
Yeah, I talked to Alias about it.
They saw me do it. Okay. I think they saw me do it to the Black Suns guy.
Oh, right.
Brysa after torched his neck.
Oh yeah,
you remember that now. Okay. Right. Okay,
but that was like the one time that I kind of openly did it
for sure. So you guys are given a reminder then that he's coming into some strange powers as well. It's like an infection. It must be airborne.
Oh my god!
Quick, breathe it in.
All right,
Elmogor's like. I really want magical powers too.
I'll run up and attack one of the ones that Xena didn't hit.
Okay.
And then that's natural 20 for 27 damage.
Wow, yeah.
These are spiders, not like.
That is actually really low. Like, I get. Twice, I get 4d6 of sneak attack damage, right? Because it's crit,
wow.
So it's 4d6 sneak attack only, right? So that's actually really low. But yeah, and then I missed with my dagger, so I will describe this one because it's awesome.
Please.
I will like do one of those epic, you know, like those half cartwheels where someone's like spinning and swinging their swords when they're dual wielding, and then it'll end up with my sword in the spider's skull.
All right, just pinning it to the ground. The rest of the body tries to get away for a couple moments, and then it just gives up. Okay, that's one dead spider. Maple.
I will try to finish that last one there after such epicness just happened right next to me.
I could do that.
All the little guys are like, one hit kills, and the big one's like...
Does 13 hit?
It does.
All right, okay, maybe not quite as epic, but... For 7 damage.
Nice. How do you kill this guy?
I poke it in its one of the really big eyes.
Oh yeah, there's a particularly large one.
Oh, that one. That.
Just it lets out a little squee as the others have, and then slowly convulses to death.
With that, I'd like to do a quick perception check around the area to see if there are any more trying to sneak up on us or anything.
Sure, yeah, give me a perception check.
19.
Okay. You're pretty confident that these are the only ones that followed you this far. You do hear a little bit of a commotion back from down the road, likely the other three guys, but otherwise there don't seem to be any sneaking up on you that you can see.
Okay.
Perhaps it was the magic that draws them, Alex, but a couple of these things skitter around to try and come at you.
I expected that.
You're lucky, though. Your fellows defending you are really doing a good job because neither of them make it through to attack. Almagar, the three that were attacking you, two went for Alias. The remaining one is not successful. You know, Pi, the one that hit you, or that you had hit, sorry, previously, is so shocked by what you have done to it. It just lets out this hiss and then runs into the bushes. And you can take an attack opportunity on it if you'd like.
Sweet.
Because it ran in backwards.
18.
Oh yeah, that's a hit.
I keep rolling ones. 7.
Okay, that is enough. You want to kill this thing running from you?
I'll just poke her in the butt.
Right. Yeah, it tries to get her away from its already heavy blood loss. Plus this, enough to kill it. All right, and then the remaining two on either pie. One will, unfortunately, while you're stabbing this thing, it just gets in there, past your shield, gives you a little nip for 2 points of damage, and I also need a constitution save, please.
14.
Alright, so no additional thing or anything else past that. Okay. Hi, what would you like to do? So there seems to be about 5 of these things.
How's Elias looking?
Better.
Better. Okay.
Not dead.
Pretty uncomfortable, kind of bloodied, but you know, ready to go if we have to.
I will then whip around, grab a handful of sand, rub it in his shoulder, and stab a spider.
Nice. Alright.
16.
Nice, that's a hit.
2. 8 damage.
Alright, so you give this thing a thrust and stab it right in its thorax. It seems to be bleeding pretty heavily, but just kind of crawls away and focuses its attention on you. This was the guy that bit you too, so I mean, fuck this guy. All right, Almagar.
All right, let's kill another spider.
Okay.
16 to hit. I rolled my 2d6s, and they were both sixes. So that's going to be 16 damage.
Very nice. All right, splat goes the spider. You just cleave in the thing, or where do you want to hit this thing to kill it?
Yeah, I think I'll just stab it like straight into its face, like just sure. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, big two-handed sword right in the face. That's always a good time. All right, Alias, what would you like to do?
I am going to attack some of these guys now.
Okay.
So I'm like they're pretty close. There's a couple.
Yeah, I mean they're within range of you. They're skittering around. Obviously, you have to watch them, but they're staying within.
Cool, cool. So whichever one of the two that attacked me recently,
okay.
We'll go for one of those first. Ooh, that is a crit.
Oh, very nice. All right. So,
that's cool. And then a six with my other sword.
That is not a hit.
And then for my extra attack on another one, do I roll that now?
Yeah.
Do I? Okay.
Well, you may as well do the damage. Oh, yeah, it's always on another one. Yeah, so no, you can do that now.
Okay. Yeah. And that'll be 13 on that guy.
Yeah, that's sufficient. So you can roll the crit damage on the first one, and then this one has to be an attack on a second guy, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so then you can roll it down for the second guy.
Cool. So for crit, you roll
your damage die twice, and bonus once.
Two sixes.
Very nice.
So that's 14 points on that guy.
Beautiful.
And then only 3 points on the other one.
Okay. Well, you definitely killed the first one, so how would you like to nuke that guy?
Oh, I don't know. So many options. I'll let you come up with something creative. I can't think of anything on this one.
Okay, because you missed with your offhand, it was actually a fake out, and the thing dodged back from it right into your other blade.
I like that.
All right, and then you give the other one a nice slash. You drag through as you're killing the first one. You just continue on with the same thrust, and it pokes the other one as well. Okay, Antimaeus.
Lonely spider. I'll engage that one. For 17 hits, right?
Yep.
15 damage.
Very nice. Okay. You kill this thing.
Perfect. And then I'll move back towards the path. Like back towards the people.
Yep. Alright. Okay. Maple, what would you like to do?
I guess I'll follow Antimaeus, head back to the party since I can hear them-ish fighting.
I'll thank Maple for the help as well.
Don't mention it.
No, seriously.
Just never mention it. Try to keep those arrows to the back of other people's heads, not mine.
All right, so the four that are surrounding Pi, Almagar, and Elias, they seem hesitant to continue to press on the attack, and they actually turn to try and skitter away. So you can each make an attack. Yeah, you can each make an attack on choice.
16.
Okay, that's it.
That's better. 13.
Very nice. Very dead.
Does 8 hit?
You.
12?
I sure should that spider.
Do I swing with both or just one?
Just one. Yeah, okay. For all the opportunity attacks, it's just one.
Cool. 6 points.
Okay. You also finish off the one that you had partially wounded. So 2 end up skittering away. And you see several eyes in the forest that had kind of creeped up while this battle was going on. And you just hear this kind of rustle in the trees and bushes as they all move away from you guys, probably running from the hill spiders later. And then all is quiet again, and we're out of initiative.
I fucking hate this place.
I didn't want to say anything, Alex, but as soon as you said that, I was like, I know what this is.
Oh, I know you know. But it's his first time ever seeing one of these things.
Okay.
To put it into context, Jordan and I, the first time we ever found like a trap door or a wolf spider,
some sort of
we did
thing
literally the exact same thing. I found one of their burrows, and I'm pretty sure we assumed it was a spider. I still poked my sword in it, and the thing came out.
Nice. I'll probably do it again next time, knowing damn well.
pull a page out of Xena's book and just light it on fire. Don't poke it. Just light it
light
on fire.
Everything on fire. That is. Doesn't matter what character I play. That is my sole purpose in D&D, is just to light everything on fire.
Light the world ablaze.
So Antimaeus and Maple will walk back and check on everyone.
Okay. Everybody seems to have lived.
I'll flip the sled back up since it was kind of like just tossed up.
You can always pull it up to use it for cover, too, you know.
That would have been a great idea. I would have had a shield. Hide behind it. Stab!
Got cover, yeah.
All right. So, what would you guys like to do?
Let's move on.
Should we resume marching order? See if we
keep
can...
Keep an eye on.
Or is that goblin... I guess I didn't see that. Never mind. Just I know that there's webs up ahead, so we should keep an eye out for that. Don't walk in the webs.
Everyone, close your eyes and run.
I've seen you scream and run off in the bush before. It wouldn't be a first.
So since you guys have already managed to make your way up there, you do easily follow your tracks up to the web. And you all see the several goblin corpses stuck in the web. And yes, here you stand. To continue on this specific path, you either need to go through or around the web. I mean, you can easily walk around the trees. It's not a big deal.
I light it on fire.
All right. Okay.
Out of my own curiosity, is this size web typical for 7-foot-long spiders? Okay. So there's probably not like a 12-foot spider hiding somewhere.
No.
I'm a little paranoid after that. So
those ones don't even need to set traps. They just walk up.
They just hang out.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, yeah, you light the web ablaze and the little strands kind of burn away. Several of the goblin bodies just collapse to the ground.
I actually want to turn and ask anyone, did any of them bite you? Any of the spiders? Anyone?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I'll show my bite marks.
What did the bites do? Did it poison you? Did it paralyze?
I think it just burned really bad.
It burned.
Yeah, a lot.
It stings.
So probably poisonous. Okay. Just curious. At least we know what we're dealing with. How did you guys already get attacked by spiders?
How did we get attacked with spiders?
I ignore her and walk on.
Where were you this whole time?
Killing the ones up away, clearing this path for you guys, you know?
Oh, you just didn't get bit. I'll remember that for next time.
It's probably a good strategy.
Oh. I was curious. I've never been bitten by a spider before.
That's what it feels like.
That's why people have phobias.
All right. So you guys continue with the path then. Can I get a new survival check from you just to continue on past this web?
Yeah.
I'm just going to turn the light so it doesn't look like I'm the devil.
That won't change anything.
But
you still are.
Kind of are, yeah.
Pinchy work, Maple. Get them to chase me and then run them straight into an angry barbarian.
That worked. We seem to fare better than the other group.
Yeah.
Roll a stealth to hide in the shadows real quick.
Yeah, 100%.
Is that a
6?
12.
Okay.
Oh! Where did my daggers go?
I just want to, like, try and emulate that gibbering mouther and try and scare everybody.
Someone's going to get a plus one great axe to the face. Or great sword, sorry.
Pi just, like, kind of wanders off into the brush and makes himself really not seen for a while, and then all of a sudden, like, a little farther ways up the road, there's this...
Dude, are you trying to get yourself killed?
So, Alias, you were, like, really paying attention to the ground, and in the meantime, you guys have been moving forward, and a very familiar sound comes from down the path. You hear this...
No.
Son of a bitch.
No.
Really?
Aren't there those ones that get the frenzy rage? No,
do we all hear that? Just me?
Oh yeah, no, everybody hears it.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna stop dead in my tracks.
I've still got my weapon at the ready. I'm looking where it came from. Like, where is that gibberish coming from?
You're also gonna notice that since this sound started happening, Pi has disappeared.
Oh no, it's got Pi.
Wasn't he like right beside me?
I know. It's...
That's the scary thing.
Well, I'm gonna.
I'm swords out.
Yeah, swords out. Head towards the south.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very... first. Ask questions later.
As you guys get a little bit closer, you notice that it's just Pythagoras fucking with you.
I'll make it look like
you just huddle in the shadows. Sorry, I had to take advantage of the fact that you went to the bathroom and didn't hear him hide. I
was going to call out on it, but I was like, would he do that? I don't know if he'd do that.
Okay. So that. I can, okay. So it's pretty obvious that everyone, yeah. Okay, as soon as I know that it's him, I'm still gonna, like, charge him. Like,
oh, shit.
You sick bastard.
Shield up. Pot tries to defend himself and stabs out.
All of a sudden, thunder wave in the face.
Oh, man. Okay, so, what did you get on that?
Yeah.
16, yeah. Right, okay, so you guys continue marching on. You've noticed that this path is a little more well-treaded than the previous area had been. So clearly they've gone this far many times, potentially to that spot where there's like that little camp, or, you know, maybe until the point where they met spiders. Yeah. But yeah, so you continue to follow this up, and it continues for about an hour or so. Can I get a perception check for you guys again, please?
So are we like 4 hours down the path or something like that now?
Yes, about three or four. Yeah.
But what are the spiders going to eat if all the goblins are dead?
10.
I'm okay if they all die. You got a 21.
Okay.
18.
Okay.
Was it from all of us?
Sorry, yeah.
Oh, that's okay. Sorry, my bad.
My bad.
18.
14.
Okay. Yeah. Essentially, all of you hear some voices from up ahead. You can't see anything, but you definitely hear something talking. Sounds very similar to the little goblin guys that you had heard previously, days past. Can anyone speak goblin? I don't remember.
Do you remember what we decided?
For we had talked about you doing goblin ish languages, but
yeah, you decided. I did. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So goblin is going to be your language. Okay.
Yeah.
So then, you understand this little goblin bickering with somebody, and he's going off about,
oh, Braca went down the road. He gets stuck in stinky. Things come out and eat him.
And you hear this other, a little bit of a deeper voice, also speaking in goblin, saying,
you lie, little whelp. The other patrols would have turned back if they had seen such a thing, and they have not come back yet. I think maybe we'll cook you on a fire and eat well tonight.
And he goes, no, I'm sorry, master. I'm telling you the truth. The Braca, he got stuck. And he goes, ah! And
crack. And all you guys hear is, Braca the Wah! Woo the Wah! You hear a thud, and then you hear a few other kind of cheers from some deeper voices, and then a few like hushed conversations among higher pitched ones.
Do they sound larger or just deeper voiced?
Do I know goblins?
You would have encountered them a couple times probably roaming through here, not often though. The deep voices you probably don't associate with anything you've seen before.
Oh, okay, so that's new to me.
Yeah, so they could be bigger, but all you can tell right now is, yeah, deeper voice.
Okay.
I'm gonna go in stealth with an 18, and then try to sneak forward.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull out my swords and kind of turn back to the group and let them know that, you know, it sounds like goblins ahead. Somebody's being called master. Maybe we can try and get the jump on them. They're seeming a little distracted. And then do like a crouched approach through the bushes.
Okay. So gradually, as you guys have been continuing on this road, the road has slowly towards the north. So you guys are heading in a solid northeastern direction. Antimaeus, as you kind of sneak up the path a little bit, you finally see where this racket's coming from after, you know, sneaking up for about 5 or so minutes. The trees have a small kind of clearing around a cave entrance. And in front of this cave entrance, you see several, like, bedrolls and a little fire. And there's at least 6 or 7 these goblins kind of huddled around the fire on their little bedrolls and that sort of thing, cooking some kind of meat over the fire on a rotisserie. But more alarmingly, you see a couple things that you've never really noticed before. And they're these very large, probably about 6.5 feet tall, 7 in some cases. There's 3 of them standing out there with kind of this deep, almost burnt orange skin color. And they seem to be bossing around these goblins. They're kicking them as they're walking by and barking orders at them in this strange language. Can I also get a perception check from you? That's nice.
21.
Okay, from inside the cave, you're also pretty positive. You hear kind of a quiet whining and a couple yelps. It kind of sounds like a dog of some kind.
I'm going to slowly pull my crossbow, and then I'm going to sneak off to, like, shuffle over to the right and just kind of try to get out of the path that I think my fellows would possibly come up.
Okay.
And then I'm just gonna stay there and wait.
Okay. Alright, how about the rest of you? What would you like to do?
Have we gotten to this clearing yet?
Sorry, are you guys all 100% marching up the road at this
point? I was.
Sorry, my apologies. Yeah. You were, are the rest of you just following Ilias?
Yeah.
Now that I know that I can tell these are goblins, that we can hear them, we've heard them before, I'm going to switch my greatsword to my hand axes.
Okay.
I'll fight little guys like little, easier to. Okay.
Like whack-a-mole, but with axes?
Yeah.
I'll take up the rear, and I'm just gonna stay back with the sled a little bit, but I'll still pull my spear and just be on the ready.
I'll be trying to be quiet, like, so I don't know how stealthy I can be, but I'll try to sneak forward.
Okay. Okay. The three of you, so Alias, Pi, and Almagar, you get to the tree line, just on the edge of this clearing around the cave. They don't seem to have noticed you yet, but you're seeing similar things I described to Antimea. So several of these kind of darker-skinned, burnt orange creatures, 6.5 to 7 feet tall, and then several goblins, like at least 6 or 7 of them, not 8.
Would I recognize, would I know what these things are?
Probably not. These guys are not really common in this area.
Okay. I wouldn't speak their language or anything.
Yeah, if you speak Goblin, you can understand them, but otherwise...
Right.
No.
Is there quite a bit of distance between us, like, in this clearing to where everybody is, or...?
Not a huge amount. It borders the cave by probably, like, 30 feet. So no. You guys are only like 10, maybe 15 feet away from the closest goblin. But they have not noticed you.
I'm going to pull out my bow.
I'm going to do the same. Yeah, I think I'm going to try to... Yeah, so I'll load a crossbow.
Okay.
And then...
Try and hide.
Okay.
Do I think if I get an actual hit that I might be able to take out one of these big guys with an arrow? Maybe.
One way to find out.
Well, yeah. That's...
You can take out people sometimes with one arrow, so...
That's fair. That's a very...
Well, valid. I don't know about Alias, but...
I might hit
I'll
the
believe
cave.
It when I see it. No.
I'm gonna aim at the entrance to the cave, and maybe there's something inside. I don't know.
Someone along the way.
Yeah.
I'll be lighting my shot up for
Did
the
I notice
guys.
Them come up?
Yeah, you do notice them there.
Super stealthy Helmagar. Actually, I should be pretty stealthy.
As soon as I see Alias draw his bow, I'll fire at one of the big guys.
Okay.
I'll do the same. As soon as I see, as soon as he one go, I'll...
I'm gonna let her fly too. At one of the big guys.
Yeah.
Okay, so each of you are firing at one of the big guys then?
Yeah.
How many did you say there were?
Of the big guys?
Three.
Okay, perfect. So I would assume I'm going to be firing basically at the one in the middle, probably, assuming, yeah. Right, I see if I walk up beside, not that I know, I don't know where Animaeus is, but... Well, I do now. Seeing the
fire. Oh, yeah, some fire out of the trees.
Aside. Somewhere to the right.
Yeah. If you guys take your shots, are you firing at the same one, the first arrow that Antimaeus loosed, or I guess you'll see what happens with it. All right,
no, I'm gonna actually fire at the guy in the middle.
Okay.
Does 20 hit?
Yes, it does.
Okay, I did an amazing crit because it's assassinate. So 33 damage.
Alright, like, yeah.
Yeah.
Full fires thud right in the head, and he just collapses over like a bag of bricks.
And then I'll reload as my move action.
Okay. Alright. Almagar, you said you're firing at the guy in the middle.
11.
That does not hit. Yeah, he just ducks after the first guy collapses to the ground. They turn to the trees.
It's all based just reload, right? That's my name.
Right, Alias.
I'll let loose at the guy that Amilgar shot at. Hopefully he's a little distracted. And...
Okay.
18. Oh, yes.
18 is a hit.
5 points.
Almagar's talking a lot of smack for someone who can't hit. Like, I can hit fire a bow any better.
All right, your arrow hits the guy right in the thigh. Lets out a just snaps the arrow and still looking out the trees. To
Perfect. Guys are. Perfect. So now he's pissed.
Yeah, he's angry. Pi, I know you're in hiding, but would you like to do anything at this point?
No, I'll stay hidden.
Just hold my ground, and I'll make sure nothing's gonna come up behind us, and I'll just keep a lookout.
Right. Sounds good. get initiative from you guys, please.
Six.
17.
Bye. 17. Almagar.
10.
All right, Alias.
I got a net 20.
Nice.
So, you still so 22.
22.
Yeah. Okay.
Nice. All right, Antman.
Save it for the battle.
I also got a natural 20.
Very nice.
Oh, you.
So that's 24.
Oh snap! Did you say the little guys are sleeping or just kind of lying
there? No, they were just huddling around the fire. Yeah. This area, because the clearing has quite a bit of snow on the ground still, so they were like trying to keep around it, keep warm. You can see me in that area. Mass, what would you like to do?
I fired a bolt for an 11 at the guy that everyone else hit once, or that Alias hit once.
Alright, no, unfortunately it does not strike him.
Okay, and then I'll use my move action to put away my crossbow.
Okay. Alright. Alias.
I'll see if I can hit that guy again.
Okay.
And sorry, Alex, I'll also use my bonus to hide.
Okay. Alright, you can give me a stealth roll then.
Are they looking over at me at this point? Like,
oh yeah, they're looking over at the forest now, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
They haven't quite made us out yet?
Yeah, they probably have a good idea. That's right, what'd you
17.
Get for
17.
Will 15 hit?
No, unfortunately not.
Ready my swords as a part, like, to end my turn?
You can put away your bow.
Okay.
If you want, and then you'll have to draw your swords next turn. Or you can drop your bow and draw your swords, but your bow will be on the ground.
You know what? I'm okay with that. I'm going to do that. Okay. Right.
Yeah, because you should be able to go a whole turn without them attacking you. Be right there attacking you. Hopefully.
Pythagoras, what'd you like to do?
Oh, shit. So, how many of those big guys are left? There's two or just one?
Two left.
Yeah, two left.
Will I get advantage if I attack from hiding? No?
In this case, because they've already fired, probably not.
Okay. That's fine.
Because they're expecting fire.
Yeah, I'll try a new spell out. I'm going to try Witch Bolt on the uninjured big guy.
Okay.
A bitch bolt. No, it's good.
15.
Unfortunately, not enough. What does that look like, by the way?
The book actually describes it as like crackling blue energy, kind of like arcs.
Cool. Yeah. Sick. All right.
So if you hit him, it might arc out and like hit little goblins.
It's a big electric
pop, 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 pop.
Yeah.
Just little goblin splatters everywhere.
That'd be so cool,
wouldn't it?
Oh, I still have an inspiration I've never used that you gave me like a while back. Can I try that?
Yeah, go for it.
Might as well use it. Why not?
Yeah,
why
not?
So, 19 to hit.
Yep, that hits.
There we go.
So you knew you were saving it for a reason.
I just kept.
I think all my inspirations got used up right away.
Yeah, all of you used it right away. Let's see, so... 7 damage.
Alright, very nice.
In other words, it just tickles them. No.
Well, right, every round, I can keep doing damage. I don't have to hit them anymore. I just do roll damage every round, so...
Oh, wow! That'll piss them off.
Just a little ant.
Alright, so your spell, this blue energy cascade, strikes him.
And continues to...
Yeah, so on my next round, I just roll damage instead of rolling to hit him. It basically just strikes him, and it stays on him. Like, it's just constantly flowing on him.
he can still move and attack.
Yeah, he can still do stuff, yeah.
Okay.
I wonder what you do.
Oh, right. So it's just him and then the goblins left, right? Or Arthur's?
Yes. Sorry, there's two guys, like two of these guys still standing. One who has an arrow in his leg, and then the one that just got shot.
That's right, right. I'm going to shoot for the one with the arrow, see if I can hit him the second time.
Okay. Hit him in the other leg.
Oops. let's try that again. Whew, 16.
So yeah, 16. 16 is not a hit, unfortunately.
Ah. At that, I'll do the same thing with my action. I'll put my bow away, or my crossbow away.
Yeah. Right. Okay, so one of the big orange guys calls back to the cave and says, "Get out here! We've got some trouble. Time to crush them. We're gonna be eating well tonight." And says, "Let the dogs loose.
No,
give them something to chew on." And
hey, he looks like Juju.
Out from the cave comes barreling these two dogs with long jet black fur and these kind of very dark red eyes. And they're just jutting towards the forest as fast as they possibly can. Also stepping from inside the cave comes another one of these large orange guys. It looks very similar to the other two that are still alive. About six other goblins follow him out. And then two additional orange guys come out that are even larger than the first two outside. And they are wearing quite nice armor. And they carry these very large two-handed blades on their back, which they're currently pulling off. And then they start shouting out commands and orders even to the other orange guys staying there. The goblins that are out in the camp right now just immediately go for bows. And they are going to try and fire upon you guys. You're partially concealed by trees right now, so that will help.
I was just going to rage against little goblins, but I'm thinking I might have to go into a bit of a frenzy now. I should have kept my like crossbow for one more round.
How big are these dogs?
Very big. About the size of the adult wolves you guys had seen
before. Lovely.
Where are those wolves when you need them? You know, enemy of my enemy is my friend, right?
Let's just let out a howl and see if they come.
Right, yeah.
Alright, so Antimaeus, you're up first with these guys. They do still, I know you're hiding, but they still are firing arrows at you. Of the several that are shot at you, one will hit for 4 points of damage. Several fire at you. Unfortunately, two find their mark. One for 6 points of damage, and the other for 5. So 11 total. Almagar. Oh my god, I am so sorry. I'm rolling really well, apparently. Two hit you as well.
So happy for you.
Yeah. For 6 damage and 2 damage. So 8 total is 2 arrows. Cut some skin on you too. They butt the trees around you.
God, I haven't even... Between the spiders and those arrows, I'm already... dropping fast.
You're the lucky one. You're able to get your shield up in the way, a couple thud into the shield, but none strike you.
Sweet.
Okay. The two injured orange guys rush towards the trees. One's gonna come for you, Almagar, the other for you, Pi. So one swings at you, Almagar, and I'm pretty confident he just missed terribly. Let's check. He definitely missed. Bye. So misses. The wolves. Coming for you, Alias. The other for you, Pi.
Can I use a reaction when I see the wolves coming at them? Can I whistle to try and get their attention to come at me instead?
Yeah, sure. Do you want to give me a charisma?
14.
Maple Toll needs to bribe these two dogs into being... then you'll each have a dog again.
We'll feed you better than they do.
Yeah. None of that goblin shit.
You whistle at them, make some gestures. They, for, you know, I must assume this is a taunt or something. And yeah, they barrel right past the rest of you guys and on towards Maple.
Just saved my life.
It's what I do.
But I'm not accidentally hitting you with weapons. I'm actually trying to help you.
Unfortunately, your heroism might make you not want to stand up the group again. So these things charge at you, and both are able to clamp their teeth down on you in various places. I need two strength checks, please.
That's the best time to talk to enemy, when they got their teeth into your flesh.
20? Non-natural. Ooh. And, nine.
Okay.
Hey, that's...
So, you take 10 points of damage total, and then one of these guys grabs your arm and just rips you to the ground, and you fall prone.
Folks, you're still a puppy dog! It's the first second.
Yeah.
Well, that's the thing, I was like, I don't need a rage for these little goblin shits, and then these big orange guys come on like... Okay, I'm feeling a little angry now. This wasn't a walk through the park like I was expecting.
That is the end of their turn. Maple, you are up.
Can I try to get up?
Yep, you certainly can. You're able to stand.
All right. What else can I do? This.
Yeah, that standing takes half of your move action, so you can still move if you want a little bit. And
do these look like regular wolves, or do these look like we fought like warg things in the past? Does it look like one of those?
These are larger wargs, but yeah, they look very similar to the warg things you fought in the past. Jet black hair, dark red eyes, look very smart, very intelligent.
So I might have something. I'll actually have something to say. Again, that's totally.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to stab the one that knocked me over.
Okay.
Twenty-three to hit.
Oh yeah, that's
a
hit.
Yeah, show me the alpha is.
Also, it's with my silvered spear. Just. Not that that made any difference. 5 damage.
Okay. So you thrust the spear into the side of this thing. It yelps and kind of does its sideways walk and just bares teeth. All right. Antimaeus, what would you like to do?
There was one on Alias, right? There's a big guy on Alias?
There is a big guy on Almagar and Pi.
Okay, nothing on Alias right now?
No. There was a wolf going towards him, but maybe
she called him off. Away.
Yeah.
Can I move to the injured orange guy?
Yep, there are two of them. The one on Pi and the one on Almagar are both injured currently.
Almagar, I think, is closer to me, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Okay, I'll go in and I'll stab him. It's 25 to hit.
Very nice, that's definitely hit.
For 15 damage.
Holy crap.
Wow.
Yep, so you kill the guy right out, stab right in the back, falls to the ground.
Is there anything...
Right in front of me, and I'm not even armed right now.
Is there anything within range, movement range?
You could get to the one that's attacking Pi. That's within a move.
Sure. Why not?
And then obviously all the there's the other big orange guy that's standing in the middle of all the goblins you could go at too.
That's fine. Okay. So that's 21 to hit. Or 3 damage.
Okay. Poke. All right, you stab him also in the back, but he does not fall to the ground dying. He grabs the wound and looks to you and Pi. Now looking like he's
I wink.
Okay. Alias, you are up.
Okay, so there's like 12 little goblins with bows out.
Just 12 little guys out.
Covering us.
Yeah, there's 2 really big orange guys. There's another orange guy standing in the middle of the goblins.
I'm going to start muttering some things to myself, and in like right in the center of all of the goblins and everything, suddenly this like dark ethereal cloud is going to start forming. It's going to be like silvery gray, and it's just going to like kind of engulf them all. I'm going to take this opportunity to go away from where they've been shooting arrows, kind of get out of the fire.
Okay.
I don't suppose I could drag my bow along with me.
Yeah, you didn't put it away, did you?
Oh no, I dropped it, so I could pull out my swords right away.
Right. Yeah, you can pick it up as your move action. That's fine. You can drag it with you.
Okay, cool.
Okay, okay, now this is fog cloud, correct?
That is the 20-foot radius.
Okay.
Heavily obscured. I'm hoping it's not windy.
It is not.
And it just moves.
Yeah. To your people. Poor idiots.
It would be just my luck.
Doesn't matter what you try to do.
Okay. Cool. Alright, so you cast that and you move out of the way of where they were firing. Okay. Hi.
I continue blasting him. 8 damage.
Alright, he crumples to the ground, dead.
I wink at Pi.
That was pretty cool.
All right. Anything else you'd like to do, Pi? Do you want to move it all right there?
No, I'll stay where I am.
Okay. All right, Almagar, you're up.
All right. So both the orange guys that were right on us are down.
They are both deceased. Yeah.
And there's a couple more coming up that just came out of the cave.
There are 3 more, 2 of which look particularly large. There are 12 goblins, kind of in an arc around them, and then there are 2 wolves back behind you.
Right. And I can see that the cloud is basically engulfed most of the goblins?
Yeah. They're difficult to see, but they also seem to be hollering at each other like they're confused as to what's going on.
Okay. How far away are the orange guys? Like, I can reach them? This turn?
You could run towards them if you wanted, yeah.
And okay, because I'd like to basically, yeah, with my great sword drawn, just run straight at and attack just the first orange guy. Or actually, I'll try to attack the big, like, just look, I'll try to look for the biggest one.
Are you raging, Scott?
Oh my goodness, thank you. I meant to go into a frenzied rage.
Okay, alright.
And then just barrel straight for the biggest guy I can see. I'm gonna.
Okay.
That's. Yeah. Oh, damn. Okay. The whole time I'm like, okay, time to rage. Don't forget to rage.
So, I know I don't do this often because it's really inconvenient over Skype, but I just really want to be clear as to what this looks like. So, if you guys will humor me, I'm going to share my screen for a sec. We'll see if this works with, like, seven people. I'm going to give you a little paint tutorial as to what this looks like.
Awesome.
I'm using a mouse, so it's going to be really bad, but anyways.
Oh, sweet, a paint tutorial.
Yeah, wow. I'm, like, legitimately saying paint. Okay, you guys
super
can see my
high
screen.
Depth. Yep, looks good.
All right, so there is this nice little cave here.
Just what I pictured.
And then there's like this little fire there. That's a fire.
You should change the color.
No.
There we go.
There's not enough silver in the cloud. No, come on.
So this is kind of the tree line here. The trees sort of go like this. The path brought you up somewhere along here. So you guys were kind of firing in. So there are a bunch of goblins essentially lined here like this. Goblin, G for goblin. There are the really big orange guys right here and right here. This is, oh god, I can't write with the mouse. That's B for big. There is the not so big orange guy right here. I'm not going to write anything for that.
Less orange.
And then there are the angry bulls, which give a nice purple, down here with maple. And you guys are kind of chilling out, sort of in this area here.
Okay.
So that's kind of what this looks like. And then this is all cliff face, by the way.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Okay.
So beautiful.
God, it's like I'm there. Experience.
I know, right? So yeah, this is just the rough kind of battle one to relax.
That's good.
I'm not gonna keep this up, but with this many people, I just want to give you guys a rough idea as to what the battlefield's looking like at the moment. So Scott, you're essentially running out here to this guy.
Okay, yeah, perfect.
Cool. All right. I'm not going to save that masterpiece.
What? Oh, we can use it as a new DM screen. Oh.
No, you guys get to look at my ugly face instead. Oh. Deal. All right, so, Scott, you just run out.
Frenzied rage, oh yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So you go for...
Now... I would assume that I'm already attacking just the big guy, but the guy behind it, does he look like he's dressed fancier or like a leader, or is he more just not as big?
You would imagine that one of the guys you just ran at is more important. They're the ones barking orders. The guy that's behind them, the only reason why he's behind them is because he was the last out of the cave. Like, he was late on his way out kind of thing.
Gotcha.
That's probably the guy that let the wolves out or something.
Right. Okay. Son of a bitch. 16.
Not quite, unfortunately.
Okay.
You swing the guy over the matrix and kind of ducks away.
Oh, so now this one will take up my tricky little second attack with my rage here.
Yeah.
Come on, I know there's a 20 left in here still. Oh, fuck. Nope.
It still looks very epic. You're swinging, the guy's dodging out of the way, getting his blade up. It's a frenzied melee going on.
Maybe I should just use my fun. I guess I'm out of moves. I'm like, take my bonus action to jump into the cloud of
and vanish.
Okay. The goblin people are all shouting in disarray. The little goblins are all confused and freaked out because they're now covered in fog and can't see what the heck's going on. So you hear a bunch of little the one smaller, still big guy, but the smaller orange guy from the back, you can hear him yell something out, goblin. You can understand them going,
Why are we clouded by evil? Oh my god, the gods are going to kill us!
And then you hear the guy in the background saying,
don't be stupid, they have a shaman of some type. Move, you grunts!
Damn it. And you see, like, little goblins, they clearly dropped their bows and they've got their little spears out, start slowly meandering out of the cloud. Oh. Because they're caution, that's all they're gonna do. They're not quite at the tree line, but they start cautiously approaching it, followed by the one orange guy. The two big orange guys there, Scott, are gonna pay you some attention. They feel like a giant guy swinging a two-handed sword at one of them is scary. So
a bit of a threat. Oh,
I didn't mean to be a threat.
Next time I'll wear my tutu.
Okay, so a serious melee begins between you and these guys. The one that you're fighting tries to take a couple shots at your head and tries to hack it straight off. You're quick enough and agile enough with your new light sword to block both of the blows. Unfortunately, this other guy, these two clearly have worked together before because they're using each other to their advantage quite substantially. And the other guy actually lands two fairly significant blows. One of which, using kind of his buddy as a distraction, sinks quite deep. Actually, probably.
This one actually hurts.
Yeah, the other one is like frenzy rage or whatever.
I would feel I'm to be like just turned around and like whoop, 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 back into the bush.
Oh shit!
I yield.
To the first attack.
Frenzied retreat.
The first attack does a whopping 6 points of damage. So barely a graze on you right now. The second one, however, 22 points of damage. Sinking deep.
But if I try to run, I get a...
Keep in mind that you are raging right now, so you do take your half damage or whatever from both of these, right? So it's actually 3 and 11.
Oh, right. Oh. Okay, that. Keep going for one more round.
Just thought I'd point that out because you looked really quite panicked. I mean, there's a lot of damage, but. Okay.
Was it for those damn spiders softening me up?
Yeah. All right, Maple. These two wolves are gonna continue to try and have at you here. Only one succeeds in giving you another nip. Can you please give me a strength saving throw?
Oh, wait, is this saving throw?
Yes.
Oh, okay. 13.
Very nice, okay. You feel like it's just about to pull you over, but you manage to stay flat-footed. The bite, however, does still break skin for 9 points of damage. Okay, Maple, you are up.
I would like to go into a rage at that last attempt there, because it nipped me and that kind of pissed me off.
Yep.
So yeah, I'll go into a rage and I don't even want to use my spear to hit the dog. I just want to kick it right in the face.
All right. You can still give me like a spear attack. We'll just consider some handy spear work and a kick instead.
Hit?
Yes, it does.
Ooh. Okay. Do I roll the same thing for that I would for my spear?
Yeah. Fine.
For 7 damage.
Nice. Yeah, I would imagine that a boot kick from a barbarian to the face would probably be quite painful, so. Alright. You kick this thing in the face.
I want to yell at them to, like, sit or yield or something. Like, you know, like some dog commands to see if maybe it'll listen.
Okay. All right. You can give me a charisma check if you wish.
Yeah. 15.
They don't seem to. Yeah, the one is now bleeding from its maw, the one you just kicked in the face, and they're just teeth bared, and they let out the occasional kind of deep and almost in a strange way guttural bark. And then they start speaking to one another in some language, out verbally, out loud. It's just like, roll, 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 roll. It almost sounds like they are kind of barking throughout their speech. But it's definitely spoken word.
There's Grim, Shaggy.
Yeah, exactly.
Can I hear this?
Yes.
Does it sound familiar at all? No? Okay.
Yes, Scooby Snacks.
Okay. Mabel, do you want to move or anything else at all? Or are you happy with the attack?
I'll stay where I am.
Okay. All right. Antimaeus.
I'll sneak up behind the one that she just booted in the face, and then I'll hit it with my short sword for 21, and then do 17 damage.
Very nice. Okay, you slice at this thing, and get a blow on some critical organ as it falls over dead.
And then.
But now, who's the other one I'm gonna talk to? Come on, Antimaeus.
I know.
Rude.
And then I'll look at Alias, and I'll tell him to deal with those goblins, and then I will.
You know I can't do that.
I'll disengage and then go hide behind a tree.
Okay.
All right. Go get them.
So the sight is Antimaeus busts out of the trees, whack, kills one of these dogs. Alias, go kill the goblins. Runs back into the trees.
Oh, what?
Yeah, pretty much, right? Just hear a burst, a smack, go deal with that, and another burst in the trees, okay. Alright, speaking of which, Alias, you're up.
Cool. Well, I'm going to... So the goblins are, like, still really confused, slowly coming out of the fog at this point?
They've come out of the fog at this point. It really, like, confused and almost kind of stunned them last turn. But they're kind of out of it, lining the forest where you guys, near where you guys are, and standing with their spears pointing out. They're probably getting ready to have the balls to charge or attack.
Okay, so because I moved off to the side, do they... They're probably not...
They're not looking directly at you at this point, no.
Okay.
No, they're more so looking where a lot of the arrows came from,
Slash the dogs.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. Then I will definitely send an arrow their way.
Yeah.
And try and hit one before they notice I'm over here.
Yeah.
Not using that one. 22.
Wow, that was definitely a hit.
For 4 points of damage.
Okay. Thud into one of their shoulders. Ah! And a few of the others all look also very scared. Ah! Don't
I love Goblin.
In Goblin, they yell, "Big man, shoot me with pointy stick! Where is he?" Other yells, "There he is! We skin him! Strip him to the bone!"
Is there anything I know about goblins that I could try and, like, intimidate them with?
Yeah, they get scared really easily, but mainly the trick is to take the head, probably literally, off their leaders.
Okay.
That's generally the strategy to deal with goblins. If you can take down the people leading them, they lose all guts.
So if they think we have a shaman, is there, like, any sort of... I'm just trying to think of anything I could yell at them to confuse
they
them.
They are very superstitious people, but... Shamans to them are just like made as a normal society. They don't really exist very often. But these guys more so believe in shamans. Like they're not shocked by it only because the concept exists to them, but it's not like they have shamans running around or anything else every day.
They still taste the same in the end, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, that's right.
That is what's important.
Okay.
Okay. Hi, Vagrus. What would you like to do?
I'm going to Sacred Spark one of the big guys.
Okay.
Probably the one that did the most damage to Almagar there.
Okay. All right.
Thanks, man.
So he just has to make a Dex 12 save.
Okay. Ooh, he definitely does not make that.
Sweet. 4 damage to him.
Okay.
And I'm going to do a bonus spell, because that's a cantrip.
Yep.
And I'm going to cast... What is it? Right, Shield of Faith on Almagar. So
awesome. Oh,
you have
wow.
Plus 2 AC.
All right.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Would you like to move it all, Pi?
Nope.
Okay, now, Pi, are you still standing in kind of the tree line area where you had originally cast that spell from?
Yeah.
Or sorry, did you? Okay.
I didn't move at all.
So, okay, so you got the goblins kind of slowly approaching you there then.
Okay.
Okay, Almagar.
See
this additional, this familiar kind of lights around you, and one of the other guys takes a burst of light to the face.
All right. I'm probably gonna go because I'm assuming they're both fairly, like, you know. I'm gonna go for this guy who just got shocked.
Okay.
It's 19 to hit.
It's definitely a hit.
Damage.
Very nice. All right.
So I guess basically what I do that is I hit him, and then same thing, I'll hit him, and then in the same action, just kind of get the other guy too.
Get back around? Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
All right.
No.
Wow,
10 doesn't hit, right?
Okay, but you do leave a fairly large wound. The Sacred Spark kind of erupted in his face. He's blinded for a moment. You just take advantage of it, strike right across the chest, opens up a wound, lets out, and his buddy is able to deflect your sword. Okay. Maple, your remaining old friend, starts. You're not sure what it's saying. Pretty sure it's not very nice.
I want to be your companion.
I don't even know what it says, but I'm just going to be like, well, I could feed you better than they can, but if you want to be like that, and yeah, I'll try and stab it in the face.
Okay. It's still down. My apologies. Sorry. It's attacking, but it does miss you substantially. Potentially.
Okay.
So grieved from the death of the evil friend.
Well, that's what I say to it.
Yeah, you are quick enough. It bites at you. You're kind of able to get your spear almost in.
What an awesome warg is a pet. Oh.
Yeah.
If you could keep it your pet.
Yeah, that's the. If it didn't try and kill you in the middle of the night, yeah.
I forgot to feed him once and he kills me.
That's why I get a dying donkey.
Wouldn't last long.
Exactly, that's why I get a dying donkey. He'll never betray you. Or will he?
He'll just slow you down.
Meanwhile, back in the village, it's got like one of the tower's veils on. It's on hind legs at night.
He's been the informant the whole time.
Yeah.
Hey, someone else can speak with animals, right? Why not?
Okay, so two big guys on you there, Scott. The one that you slash across the chest comes in for a very aggressive attack. Apparently he didn't like that you hit him. And he just so brutally misses that he actually cuts into his buddy's arm a little bit.
Turn them on each other.
It's always good when like when the DM's characters like crit fails, right?
Potentially distracted by his friend cutting a hunk of skin out of his arm, the other guy misses horribly with both of his strikes towards you. So you leave unscathed as the battle continues so far. Okay, moving towards you, Pi. Six of these little angry dudes are gonna command their commander and just charge into the woods.
If they just wait a little bit longer, their commanders will be dead and they won't have to.
Mm-hmm. They'll be free goblins.
Yeah. Free to die by our swords.
They're stabbing at you with their spears, and your shield gets up in the way. No problem. The one that Alias hit, he is clearly very wounded because he slips on some of the snow and falls and he cracks his head on a rock and just dies. But the other five, you're able to hold at bay. Their commander follows them behind. He's gonna take an attempt here too, and zero luck. Pie the guy. The other six are heading towards you.
Sorry, Alex, did you say one hit me?
No, sorry.
None of them hit me, okay.
One was a complete idiot, the one Alias had hit. he had gone with this troop still, slipped, fell, hit his head, died.
I'm not convinced these other ones are coming after me. I think you should double check.
Oh, no, according to this, they still are.
Damn. Worth a try.
Alright, you're just about as agile and lucky as Pythagoras, but not quite. So two will strike you.
Been fun, guys.
Just little gob.
You just need some hit points.
Yeah, well, I had some, and then I pissed off some spiders.
You're quite lucky on the damage this day.
Oh, thank
God. So you take a total of 4 points of damage.
Buys me one more round.
Alright. That is them. Maple, now you may stabby.
Okay, yes, that's what I'd like to do.
Right.
And yell at the war that...
Yeah.
18 to hit.
Oh yeah, that's a hit.
Nope. Just try that again. For 12 damage.
Nice. Right. Stab your spear into the wolf, and it seems a little more hesitant to approach you. It takes a step or two back. Okay.
I'll take a step or two forward.
Alright.
Yeah!
Not getting away that easy. Alright, Antimaeus.
I run in and attempt to stab the wolf for 14.
14 is a hit. Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
For 13 damage.
Nice. You get a very large blow on this thing. You cut, you're pretty sure you strike a rib as you cut in. And you withdraw. The wolf is semi-limping back. It's in rough shape, gushing blood, but it still lives.
I'll swing with my dagger then if it's still alive. It's 14 to attack again.
Yep, so that's it.
For an additional 2 damage.
Okay. You slit its throat.
Yes!
I can try and take some of these little bastards out with my short swords.
Alright.
There's six.
Yeah, there's six. Yeah. And they're saying some really rude things to you. Saying that your flesh looks pretty juicy, that you'd be hard to get up on a rotisserie, but they think they could do it.
That's a compliment.
Start speaking back.
Well, 13. Do I have to get my extra attack? Do I have to hit with one of the first few?
Didn't say
No. Yeah, your ranger thing gives you the second attack just right off, and then you can use your bonus action to use your third attack. Yeah.
Can I run instead?
You can do
two swings.
You can do a bonus attack and run if you'd like.
Okay. Yeah, let's do that. okay, there we go. 19.
Oh yeah, that's a hit.
There we go. First two misses pissed me off. And 7 damage.
Nice. How do you kill little guy?
I'm gonna kind of do like an uppercut and just kind of like try and lift him and toss him. I don't know how big these guys are.
Flick him in the trees. Like,
throw him back to his buddies and I'm just gonna run.
Throw
him right into his buddies.
Yeah, that's sufficient. Yeah, the goblins aren't that heavy. Just, and you thrust them back. Ah, hits them.
Catch them.
Yeah, they semi catch them. Catch them a little bit with their spears, even. Yeah. And then, you just jut off. Okay.
Perfect.
Okay.
That'll be
nice move.
Antimaeus.
Okay, towards Antimaeus. Alright. So you don't quite get to them this turn, but you can easily get there next.
That's alright. Just build space.
All right, Pythagoras, what would you like to do?
So what's the situation right now for...
You've got five little guys in front of you, and then one of the orange guys behind them.
Hmm.
And then, other than that, Alias is running back to the woods. He's got five that look to be attempting to trail him. And then Almagar is fighting the two really big orange guys.
I will... do my favorite move, Thunder Wave.
All right.
so 12 con save.
Okay.
Eight damage, and they get pushed 15 feet away from me.
Okay. Is it half damage if they succeed, or is it always 8 damage?
And no, it's half damage if they succeed and they're not pushed away.
Okay. All right. Well,
just splatter ball against the cliff wall.
It's an effective goblin killer. Killed them last time.
Yeah. 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 Four just spurt into bloody messes from this thing. Another one gets extremely close to the same treatment as he flies 15 feet back and just rolls onto the ground. The orange guy holds his ground, but clearly is not looking too happy after that. You can see like his nostrils are bleeding. So he probably like broke something in like, his skull or in his nose or something from this. His
frontal lobe's like all. Yeah.
And one of the guys that were chasing Alias is actually close enough as well to. He did not fall, but he's holding his ears.
He's just tossed sideways.
Yeah. All right. Okay, very effective goblin killer. Anything else you'd like to do?
Let's see. How far away would I be if I ran into the group of goblins chasing Alias from Almagar?
From Almagar?
Yeah.
At this point, you'd probably be 50 feet-ish away.
Perfect. Yeah, I'll do that. I'll just kind of run right into them.
Okay. All right. Okay, Almagar.
All right. Is there just, there's both the orange guys are still in front of me?
Yep. Yeah, they seem very preoccupied with the screaming, raging barbarian that's managing to take hunks of flesh out of them. And rightfully so, if you ask me.
This time, instead of going for the guy in the left first, I'll do just the opposite, like hit the other one first.
All right.
18 again.
Yes, that's a hit.
And we are going to do 12 damage.
Very nice. All right. So that you do a very similar wound to this guy that you did to the first guy. So now they both have these big gaping wounds across their chests, and they're just bleeding right out of that.
Twinsies.
And then, so yeah, now my second attack will go for obviously the other guy.
All right.
Oops. Need a bigger rolling surface. Sorry. Oh, this should be that hard. 17.
17 is a hit on these ones, yeah.
Oh.
Nice. Okay. A sight to behold as you're just like batting away their weapons. Slash. Slash. Yeah. And they're starting to look like they're a little worried. The fear is in their eyes. Okay. Not to mention the goblins that are now like pissing themselves out of fear. Okay. The five that you ran towards Pot. Let's see what these guys are going to do. Or sorry, the four. My apologies. No, five. One's injured. Dead.
Yeah, I kind of just wanted to like run in and block their path.
Sure. Okay. Two of these guys are going to shout something and just turn tail and run. You can take a slash at one of them if you'd like.
Nope.
All right. So they're just running away with their spears. The other three are looking at them, very confused. But one pokes, and then the other two kind of follow suit, try and poke at you. Just so stunned that nothing's gonna happen. I just rolled three dice for the record, and I rolled the same number on each die. That
doesn't happen. Wow! It's like an instant win or instant kill.
Yeah. Fail. If three crit fails, I'd find a way. The one goblin that had survived your shockwave that wasn't an alias group, that was in the group that was in front of you there. He looks like he wants to turn tail and run, but the living orange guy just pushes them on, so they come at you. Big hulking large guy swings, you're able to deflect it, but it unfortunately the little guy is a little luckier and strikes you somewhere that's a little bit more painful. For 11 points of damage as the spear just finds gap in the armor and gives you a little stab.
Well, fuck that guy. I'm going to use an ability I keep forgetting about.
Okay.
it's called Wrath of the Storm. So when I'm hit, I can use a reaction to cause to make a Dex 12 save or take 2d8 lightning damage.
Yep.
Oh.
I always wondered why you weren't using that, but I figured.
Maybe yeah, I keep forgetting. Holy shit. 15 damage?
Oh yeah, little guy blows up. he's like, ah! It looks like he has just this great time stabbing you, and then just his eyes go wide as fear is
just like, ah! Just explodes.
I love exploding goblins.
Yeah, that's the best. Okay, so that's those guys. The got him on the run, apparently. currently. They are swiping at you, but you're just deflecting these blades like it's no problem. And slash, slash, slash. Yeah, they've got nothing on you right now. So neither of them, successfully hit. Okay.
What's your AC now, Magar? I'm just curious.
It's a 18.
With that spell?
Yes.
Cool. That's awesome.
Yeah, yeah. Less than before, but that's... I'm no longer, like, extra special magic.
All right, Maple. So, Antimaeus is here with you. Alias, you can see running towards you through the trees. And kind of behind him, there's Pi dealing currently with a few goblins.
How far away are those goblins? Can I get to them within this?
If you did like dash and use your whole turn to get there, you could get there. Otherwise, you'd be just a little bit off from them.
I don't know how this works. I should probably look it up because I'm just staring at the book right now. But is it possible to do a dash? Get to them? Can I just shove one? Like, or is that still out of range?
You can get to them. I'm not sure how that works, actually. But, you know what? I'll look this up after the session, because it's something we never encountered with. But yeah, just for right now, so we don't waste time looking at rules.
Because I'm enraged. I just want to go up there and just, like, kind of, like, run up with my shield and just kind of shove them and just, like, keep going.
Definitely. If you've got athletics, you can roll that or strength. If you don't have athletics,
I have athletics.
All right.
Nice.
So natural 20.
Yes.
And I have 6 in athletics, so 26.
Oh, yeah. No, with a nat 20 and a DM who has got no idea how this works, the injured guy that had like the hurt ears is still kind of grabbing his head a little bit. You're just boom, and he falls back, cracks his head on a tree, and just. Flew a couple feet.
Goblins are so cute when they die.
Yeah, Mabel and that shield bash, though.
Yeah.
Pretty deadly. Okay. So, Antimaeus, if you like to.
How close is the Almagar fight from Antimaeus?
Approximately 50 to 60 feet away.
That is highly unfortunate. but I'll dash to him, and then I rolled an 18 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
And then, so that's...
Which one do you want to hit? One is a little bit more injured than the other.
I definitely want to not be hit, so I'll go for the injured, way injured guy. Right. So I'll go for the hamstring and do 15 damage.
Very nice. Yeah, you cut the hamstring. He falls to the ground, writhing in pain a bit, and the blood loss is too much. And the eyes roll the back of his head. But perfect. Okay. Alias, what would you like to do? The goblins that were following you seem to be engaged with Pi. Xena, or people just ran there and punted one against a tree.
Excellent. How many are left? Sorry?
There are 4 total, plus their orange guy.
Big guy?
Yeah. It's also quite neat.
Cool. I'll head back and kind of come from the side and try and take a couple out. The big guy's looking pretty injured, like... Okay, I'm gonna try and focus on him.
Okay.
And then I'll do my bonus attack on one of the little close guys.
Sure.
19?
Yep.
7.
that is not it.
Yeah. I'll roll damage on that one first. Ooh.
6 damage on the big cat.
Very nice. You kill him.
Sweet. And then 11 on one of the little guys.
Not enough. No. Actually, no. Okay. Pythagoras. So there are 4 little guys left, and Antimaeus and Almagar are fighting the last really big guy.
Alright, I guess I'll do Thunder Wave again.
Okay.
It's so fun. what was it again? 12 con. Yeah. 10 damage.
Alright. 2 of these guys fly against trees and crack their heads and die. The other 2 barely stand their ground, wavering, blood just dripping from their mouth and nose, and they just look absolutely terrified. okay. I'm with her.
There's still an orange guy alive, isn't there?
There is one big guy right in front.
Alright. of course, I'm still ranging. I'll still have my big, you know, growl and yell. You know, oh, because now is when I need to do this. It's got a natural 20.
Nice. Very, very nice.
I like the die.
Finish him.
Oh, man, yeah, this, oops, I don't think I can see it very good. Oops. Yeah, no, it's actually their Dwarven dice. Pretty awesome. Just arrived today in the mail. It's my birthday present.
Just savor it.
21.
Oh my god.
Oh man. How do you kill this guy?
You just cut him in half, don't you?
And again, and this is my new weapon, and this new weapon is just amazing. So I am literally just going to, I'm just going to just try to cut him right in half if you can.
This weapon making that fury and strength makes this guy like butter. just leave him right in 2. Both halves try and walk away. He collapses into a messy pile of blood and flesh. Okay. Anything else you'd like to do?
I basically keep my like weapon like that, and I'll just turn down a mess and be like, "Oh." Well, because he just had an awesome shot too, but I was like in the middle of fight, just like, "Ah, nice shot."
Yeah. All right. I'll point at the remaining guy.
That's right. There's still the little orange. Well, the little big orange guy.
No, he's dead.
He's dead.
Alias took care of him.
It's just a goblin left?
It's just 2 little goblins. Both very living.
And their leaders are...
and these 2 little goblins are going to try and run away. So, Alias, Pythagoras, and Maple, you can each take attack opportunity on the fight. And they're just like...
I got a natural 20. Yes.
Oh. Situation that could be a hit because the kids are just desperate. I got 16. Alright, you guys hit all around.
16.
For 10 damage.
Oh, 8 damage.
They didn't stand a chance.
We just circle these guys and start pummeling them.
We just keep shaking them. Yeah.
I'll give you guys some insight that these guys each had 2 hit points left, so it's just like such overkill. It's just like and they just are in pieces and collapse.
That was kind of my plan, just because I was kind of in my frenzy that if there are any goblins left near me, I'm just gonna pick them up and just rip them in half.
Bash their skulls together.
Yeah. pick one up and just start killing the others with them. Use it as my weapon. Improvised weapon, right? Use a live goblin as an improvised weapon.
Yeah. Oh, that's so good. All right. Well, you guys are out of initiative. That cleans up the rest of this little mini goblin horde. Good job.
That was awesome. Those orange guys were getting out of
few. Let's get out of here. Nope.
Oh my god, all of our leaders died in 6 seconds.
Run!
Well, I thought I was going to have to run too. I forgot about having the damage, because I'm like, okay, I'm going to turtle and run and hope their attacks of opportunity don't take me under below zero.
Oh. Alright, so what would you guys like to do in this camp? What's the next step?
I'm going to head straight for the cave myself. Yeah, how are you guys?
I still have a few seconds left of rage unless I actually attack something, so I'm using that to run directly into the cave as fast as I can go.
I'll follow her.
If I see, yeah, and I'm going to...
How do healer's kits work? Can you actually like heal yourself with those? Or are those only, for stabilizing?
Only if you have a trait, I believe, called physician or healer or something.
Definitely.
So
yeah. Okay,
for
never
anybody
mind.
Else, it's just purely stabilization.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Oh, okay, well, actually, you're probably pretty badly injured, and I can see that, right? So
it's going to be pretty obvious, yeah.
Instead of charging in, I'll go use a healer kit on him.
I'm going to put my weapon away, and I get, like, obviously, I can't see far into the cave, right? It's dark, so I'll put my weapon away and get a torch out and light that. I've got my tinder and whatnot.
Okay.
For what it's worth, this cloud that was in front of the cave is gone by now.
Okay. All right.
All of a sudden, now the girl's like, oh my god, where am I?
You get six back there, aliens.
Thank you.
Alright, so Almagar and Maple, you rush into the cave. It's not a huge cave. It's just sort of like a little outcropping. There's a makeshift cage kind of set up within it. It's really spears more than anything else. You don't think that anything probably could have really kept in here unless it had a reason to be in there, but this must be where the wargs were kept. There's also two chains with hooks hanging from the roof, and it appears to be a family of several bears that were more than likely inhabiting this cave when these guys showed up. And they're hung there, they've been skinned, and they're clearly using them for food of some kind.
That's it.
How'd you make out against those wargs anyway? Obviously, they're not a problem anymore. They took a bunch of a fight.
as we're
looking around.
As I'm still, yeah, looking around, running in, and be like, yeah, they're dead.
Too bad you couldn't have one of those as a companion or a.
Probably not very obedient. Now that you're closer to the cave, too, and that you're kind of in the outcropping of the camp, you're going to notice that this kind of cliff face appears to level out up top, and there looks like there's kind of a rough path that may even have at one point, they don't really look like stairs anymore, but may have been stairs at one point that would allow you to climb to the top of the of this rock face.
So that's what everyone else, but like, well, I guess we don't see that inside the cave, but everyone else sees that.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious. You guys would have probably seen it approaching the cave, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Alright, yeah, I'll go up there and check it out.
Yeah.
So I'm not seeing any chests or I can't imagine they would. I haven't been there that long, so it's not like they've amassed treasure.
I'll follow in, and I rolled a 24 for investigate, so I'll start looking around as Almagar's has the torch up for me.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll kind of go over like wherever you kind of go, I'll kind of follow it, and you know, I'll be looking myself.
Pai, you said you were going up?
Yeah.
I'll come with you.
So you're pretty confident that there's really nothing of value in this place at all, which is odd. And the biggest reason that's odd to you guys is because you know these guys stole things from the villagers. So they had to have brought it somewhere. And this isn't the place. So this looks like they might have been camped here for a bit, but this likely isn't their main home.
Would be a good place to rest.
I was just gonna say I'm gonna take a short rest. I mean, we're looking, but I'm not exerting myself. And then, I'd like to.
How many hours did it take to get here?
Just about 3.5.
Oh, okay, so it's still, we would have left fairly early, right? So
yeah, it would still be like midday.
Okay.
Who all went up top?
It's me and Alias.
Yeah.
Is there a fire going in the cave? I should have.
No, just outside of the cave.
Just outside, okay.
Yeah, which is low burning now.
Okay. I'm just going to ask, you guys done in the cave here, or do you want to take the torch?
Yep, no, let's head back out.
I don't think there's anything else in here.
I don't know how that, like, torch, torches, once I extinguish it, is it basically considered used, or can you relight a...
As long as you didn't, like, it's personal.
Something we burned for maybe, like, 10 minutes or something,
yeah,
right?
No, so no, then that's totally fine. It's if it gets pretty close to the end of its life, then, and you put it out, then, yeah, it's probably done, but it's fine.
Okay.
Okay, so Alias and Pythagoras, you climb up these stairs. As you're moving up them, there's been a lot of overgrowth over them, and plus the snow. You don't see a ton of it, but as you're stepping, they're becoming uncovered a little bit, and they look like a hewn, fairly finely crafted stone, but it's almost like a white stone. So definitely not natural to this mountain face, 100% added.
Does it resemble that of the ivory tower? Or just coincidentally white?
It definitely has similar traits. But I wouldn't describe it as the exact same material. But it's equally nicely crafted. Maybe not the same stone, but kind of got that white, stark white feel. Yeah.
And it's definitely not been recently traveled on with all the snow and stuff? Okay.
Yeah, no, definitely not. Yeah. So when you guys get to the top, you'll notice that the area up here is actually almost completely flat. And this is what you see. There are two... it's a little bit farther away from the edge of the cliff, which is why you couldn't see it from down below. But there is a large statue of a person. And it's probably about 13 or 14 feet tall. There's a small river running a little bit beyond it with a wooden bridge that arcs over it. And on the other side of it is another statue of equal height. And then lining kind of the path from statue to statue are pillars kind of on either side of where a path would be. And they're broken and kind of half-hewn and that sort of thing. So this is definitely an ancient area. There's a lot of overgrowth on the statues and on the pillars, but the statues themselves seem to be in pretty good condition.
Are the statues the same? Or are they different from another?
It's tough because you're looking at one from behind right now, but you're pretty confident they're different. Like, the poses look different. But yeah, they're likely different.
Could I go check out these statues and maybe discern if I know what they are of?
Yeah, sure. Do you have religion? Why?
I do now.
Okay.
Uh, 11.
Okay. Do you have history?
Yep.
Or religion?
No, I don't.
Okay. But you've got history, Pi?
Yeah.
You can give me a roll on that as well.
While he's doing that, I'm going to give like a whistle to the guys down below. Just kind of like wave them up.
20.
In case they didn't see us.
Okay. Yeah, the rest of you will see Alias. Alias call you up.
Hi. Yeah.
So, Pi, you do recognize these two figures. While these are very well-known people, their images aren't shown very much anymore in this kind of form. It's a little tough to see. But these are actually two statues to the goddesses Engeli and Irien. One is the goddess of nature and fairness, and the other one is god of creation and new life. Hmm. And the statues are facing each other, so it's almost like they're kind of looking at one another. They look like they're made of the same material the steps are made of.
What would be like a typical time to like pray for? Like how long would a usual prayer be?
Most of the prayer to these kind of goddesses are done in the mornings. It's kind of with the rising dawn sort of thing. And, you know, everyone's probably taken part in at least one prayer in their life to these goddesses. So you could, you know, recite something in about, you know, half an hour or so if you want to do like something really formal. Otherwise, you could do a quick.
I've gotten to be a little more revering of the gods now, so I kind of want to do that.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So you can do kind of a ritual. And for it being the top of a mountain face where there's just a bunch of goblins surrounding it, oddly enough, like, this is a very untouched area. The river is almost kind of frozen over, but it retains a lot of its beauty. And there are even some plants up here that are covered in snow, yet still maintain kind of their bright red hues and bright yellow hues. You can imagine that in the spring or the summer, this is probably quite a beautiful little spot.
Yeah, this would be a good place to actually rest, I think.
I was going to say, they wouldn't have taken long, right? I wouldn't have had time to have a short rest down below. Because as soon as Aelius kind of whistled up.
Yeah, you guys have a couple options here. You can do just a short rest and regain hit points that way. Or if you guys want to do a long rest, you can, but it'll take you all the way to the next day because you've had a long rest fairly recently.
Yeah, no, I was just thinking if I had enough time resting down here, the time it took them to climb,
Oh, okay. You could take a short rest if you'd like, yeah.
Okay. So I'll just look at the others. Is that, shall we join them up top? Apparently they must have...
Yep.
The path doesn't look too good, but might as well check it out.
And yeah, I'll let everyone know that these are the statues of the goddess Ariane and Emgali and all that, so...
I'm actually gonna go back down the trail, and I'm gonna just kind of off the path. I want to remove like the warg bodies and all that, and just kind of push them off into the brush. So if anyone does come up those trails in the meantime, at least they're kind of possibly hidden a little bit, other than the fresh blood splatters all over the place. But
sure, okay. All right. You head up to do that. The rest of you that are up top on the mountain, or the cliff face, you'll notice something else. Sorry. So standing up here, Pi, you do your prayer, and then you guys have a chance to look around a little bit, and you're actually going to notice that the height of this gets you a very good view of above the trees for a few miles. You can even see a little bit of smoke where likely Briac is. Maybe even in the far distance you can see Umbermill. Some kind of smoke rising from that. And you can definitely see where the tree line breaks a little bit more towards the north, and you can see the tower in the very, very far, far distance away. looking over the trees a little bit more to the northwest, you can see the mountains in the northwest there. Maple, you had said that you had spent some time up there, I believe. So if you do end up wandering up to this platform, you'll identify those are the mountains that were kind of, you know, maybe a little bit of home, a little bit of adventure to you at some point.
Cool.
And fairly close to you guys, probably within a few hours' journey, you can actually see poking just above some quite tall trees some sort of building made of this white hewn stone with overgrowth kind of growing over top of it. And you can see a big symbol of a star just poking above the trees on the top of this of the roof of this this structure. And it's not the same scary white star thing of a Fikir. This is a totally different different one. It looks more like a typical, like, say, North Star type symbol.
Well, my Pythagoras is praying. I'm going to do an investigation around this area for 17.
Okay. Anything in particular you're looking for?
Anything that is of value. So anything that is not stone.
Sure.
So any doors or anything, because, again, still thinking from the standpoint of they stole stuff, so where'd they put it?
Okay. Nothing of note. However, one thing you will see, and Pythagoras is doing his prayer, there's a little dip in the base of the statue, almost like a bowl that has been almost completely covered over by vines, but you, looking around, will notice this. And covered in dust and some dirt from the plants are several coins that you do not recognize in any way.
I'm fairly wise, so I will leave those alone.
Okay.
Assuming that they're offerings of some kind.
Okay. You will notice, without touching, just by seeing, they have that same star symbol on that building that is kind of over the horizon on the back of them, stamped on the back. All right. But otherwise, yeah, unfortunately, nothing of note, no supplies, nothing like that.
Once I'm done praying, I'd like to mark the location on the map, if I can, of this place.
Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
we'll probably want to remember this.
Good idea.
I will add it to the map on Facebook as well.
This would be a good little place for our own little encampment.
Potentially, if we clear it out.
That's the goddess of nature.
Oh.
Just so you know.
Well, now I know. That's half the battle.
And I think, guys, I know we still have a little bit of time, but I think this is a good place to leave it. You guys